Just waiting on those names to come in yet. Right, so just going in. Now rocking the Ravenous Melina. Not a variation we see very often. Saltface letting us know that he approves of Ravenous Melina. So Grobiwon going with Shaolin Kung Jin. Sorry, K9. Oh my, I'm sorry. I'm calling him sorry.
Yeah,
I'm calling him sorry. Yeah, I'm not going to call him oh my god.
Oh my god.
Here we go. Opting not to go for the armor breaking setup. Oh, just goes for the EX roll. Does not connect.
I guess he went for the stagger and went for the counter. He was trying to get a counter poke to come out.
You know, it's still pretty decent. Sorry, taking the first round. Letting that EX roll whip. I mean, if it works, it works. Yeah. If it's going to work, you're going to condition him eventually.
That's what Melina's all about, really, in any variation. It's about conditioning your opponent to when they want to press the button, when they want to jump, and react accordingly, or plan accordingly.
And she's just sitting here full screen, just being able to do whatever she wants, controlling the screen, neutral jump punch, all these combos. I love the execution. That does some really decent damage.
Ooh,
and boom, it right in like the that. Face. Oh, it's so disrespectful, but it's so good. So sorry, not sorry, getting the brutality for the first match. Gonna go ahead right into it. Grobiwon having a lot of problems from full screen, but when he's up close, he's doing pretty well.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's. And that's where Melina kind of controls a lot of the characters in the game, is full screen, because you have to come to her. And it's not easy.
And it's really not, and I think he's gonna start picking up on that really quick. Oh, this guy is pulling out every trick in the book.
That was something I would do. It's with something and armor, because someone's you're gonna press a button.
You know what, man? No fear just seems to be paying off. Why not? If he hasn't blocked it yet, why not?
And right there from Broby, he had the chance to punish there if he'd have just done a stand one and then an instant air dive kick, but opts to try the full combo and just completely drops it.
And sorry, just going all over the place right now. He's kind of unstoppable at this point. He's pulling out every trick in the book at the right moment.
Just like that.
Standing two stagger into EX overhead. This man is a god among men. Just letting it rip.
I want to say that was a whiff punish on reaction.
It looked like it was. And he's playing it perfectly because he's just playing so fast. Grobiwon just can't keep up. And that's the second match.
Yep,
that's
2-0. This is kind of the PL. Get in there. Get quick.
And you know what? And that's what works out. For PL especially, you know, a lot of people are like, oh, this playstyle is not supposed to be working right now. But you know what? When you play all over the place and at such a fast pace and just going with it, going with your gut feeling. I mean, look at what's happening. Look at what's happening.
And you know, that amplified by a variation that not a lot of people see, he's going to get away with a lot.
And even though the normals are somewhat familiar, the overheads that Ravenous has, those normal overheads, are going unpunished, and he's doing it into roll because he knows. He knows deep down Grobiwon isn't ready for a Ravenous like this.
Oh, and that's just leaving money on the table right there by Grobiwon.
Sorry, K90 is just... I'm sorry, K9. I honestly don't even know. I'm trying to figure it out mid-set.
Here we go. This could be for Roby.
One more setup. Is he going to do it? And he baits it a mile away.
We finally see something solid out of Roby here.
Now, and this is one of the beautiful things about a first of three. You pick up on tendencies late in the set.
Look at that.
And we're slowly seeing Grobiwon adjusting to Sari's insanity, I'm going to call. I'm going to call this calculated insanity.
Okay. Is this the 90-day workout?
This is it. This is P90X insanity.
P90X insanity. Because Grobiwon's getting a workout right now.
He is. He definitely is working for this, but you know what? It's starting to pay off. Going into the corner, keeping it relatively simple, but still getting decent damage in there. 36% is respectable.
Ooh,
did I just break
right
armor?
That did. The flying kick has like a 9-frame startup. It's quick.
And it's two hits up close. Very nice bait. That looked a lot like a punish.
It did.
That looked a lot like a punish on the EX overhead kick by Kung Jin. So now Sari is on set point right now, but Grobiwon taking the first round. He's in there. And Sari is just counterpoking with rolls. He is not caring until Grobiwon has something to show for it.
Which has been known to cause some salt by going under poke.
Yeah, that's another thing too. For all we know, Grobiwon is extremely playing on tilt right now.
Yep.
After everything that's been happening. From the outside looking in, it just looks like Ravenous is just getting away with these tricks.
Very nice armor break there. Going to convert into the full combo, into the hard knockdown, 35%.
Yo, got Smokey here. Oh, there we go. He has to watch out for roll here. Oh, and here it comes.
And this is it. Now, both of them are sitting on no bar. One or two more touches, and that's it. And going for it. Needs to be careful.
So he's going to armor. Yep, here we go.
Is this going to kill? It is. That's it. Sorry, nine. Sorry, not sorry.
Sorry, K9, OMG. Sorry, K9, OMG. Your ravenous Melina of this pool.
I honestly didn't know. It was so hard to keep up. This man was so calculated from what it seemed. Sending it off, Roby Wan definitely not happy.
Yep.
Shaking his head right now. But it's going to happen. Every pool is going to have that guy that goes down the first match, but it doesn't mean them out.
Sorry, just walked off so calm and collected, smiling. Just like, yeah, that's how I play Melina.
I can't do this, man. I can't see this insanity. Emperor Outworld.
Okay, I thought he was going up the station there, but he's going to charge his phone.
I would have loved to see it. Emperor Outworld.
Here we go.
This is gonna be good.
The man versus RM Cloud coming up next on deck.
The man, the myth, the legend. Kevo the man.
Kevo
the
man.
Emperor Outworld. Make America. Making TYM.
Make TYM great again.
Emperor Outworld, for those who do not know, made the absolutely godlike threat on TYM.
It was
the godlike threat.
Well, like he always does. Let's be serious here.
This man is notorious. And he's getting hype. We're slowly going to be getting a crowd here for this match.
And we've got Kevo the Man here representing Hazardous Gaming, who picked up a couple. Kevo and one of his training buddies, XX Dark, who is a dark horse in any pool.
You know what? And he was a dark horse in the beginning. This man is slowly starting to become numb. Dark is the name that everyone has been talking about.
There are three guys that train together. Dark, Kevo, and this next name everyone's going to recognize. I'm Aura. We all know that name from ESLs and the NEC of last year.
I'm not a fan of that name. You know why, right?
I know why.
Yeah,
that's
why
I brought it up. Big D. That's why I brought it up.
Of course he did. For those that do not know, I love Imor. I think he's a great player. I am still salty this day because in one of the weeks in ESL, I managed to eliminate Sonic Fox in top 16 or top 32 and proceed to be eliminated 3-1 to
Imor's Reptile.
Is he here this weekend?
No, he's not.
Oh.
Not that I've seen.
He has,
so there's someone in our scene named Sid the Hayes, another
of
common
course,
name,
of course.
Who is 0-3 against Imora. Salty as can be every time the name comes up. And Aura loves it. I got, I'm 1-0 against him, and he gets to be salty about that.
Yeah, he has to hold that. Are you kidding? That's how that works. Now, we have Kevo going up against, now this is RM Cloud. Correct?
Yes, this is RM Cloud. With the biggest Charizard ever seen on God's green earth.
Oh my God.
Jesus.
Dude, I thought that was part of his shirt.
No, that is a sprite.
That can't be comfortable to wear. That cannot be comfortable to wear. Look at that. That's like 10 pounds right there. What is that?
That's a wall art.
I love it. I actually love it. That's not Charizard, man. What the hell?
That's Mega Charizard.
Are you lying to me?
I'm not lying to you. That is Charizard.
I'm going
to
go with your name. If I get blown up in the stream chat because that's not Charizard, I'm going to be extremely upset with you.
It's Charizard. It's
I don't know.
No
I'm not
other dragon
out
of
cool,
anything.
You
it's,
cool kids and your Pokemon Go. And your.
It's from the last generation. You know, where, you know, they could turn into the other things.
Stop blowing me up, man. I'm trying my best here to keep up with you cool kids. Now, I'm assuming there's a bunch of just going ahead and make sure everything's looking all good. Kevo the Man rocking Piercing Melina. RM Cloud rocking his signature Bone Shaper Shinnok. So I am really looking forward to seeing this.
Yeah, Kevo, who's notorious. Okay, I like to talk about Kevo as kind of the guy that picks the flavor of the month.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, of course.
He goes
with whoever's the best character. Yeah. And if
just like an
MK9. He's been notorious for this for years. But that's just who he is. If you want to play to win, you got to pick the best. If you're going to – I mean, everyone plays with their own.
Yep. And right
that
now
– what he likes to do.
Right
it's
now,
been working out relatively.
Yep. Right now he's got Piercing Melina coming off of second at Defender North.
Only losing to Destroyer in Grand Finals.
Yep. He got double eliminated by Destroyer, and that was it.
Which hopefully we get to see a run back. That would be hype.
But here we go. That would be hype. Fight.
Let's get this thing going. Hazard Kevin the Man up against RM Cloud. Opting to go for the armor break. Now, RM Cloud is going to try and bait out all of these EX rolls to get himself conditioned. to make respect, to make Kevl respect the fact that he knows when the craziness is coming. But other than that, Kevl in the beginning is just going to be running all over. You're going to be seeing a lot of the tricks out early on until they don't work anymore.
Looking to see, yeah, like right there. He knows right now that he can get away with teleport, which is not good if you're facing a Bumbleina player.
And Kevl just looking dominating right now, taking the first round almost unscathed. Back one.
I don't know what.
That's not even a thing, but you know what? And that's a mental statement right there.
That really
RM
is.
Cloud is trying to adjust, and he just can't.
And he's just continuing this just utter dominance. He's just he's inside his head right now.
RM Cloud needs to make something happen. He needs to break it. He's going for a late break here. He needs to make something happen. Kevl just trying to let it rip to get the first match over with nice and quick.
Yeah,
into the restyle now.
All of this is just to get another roll. Oh, and he takes with the interactable there.
And there you go, just like that. A very quick first match for Kevl. RM Cloud needed to take a second there just to get something going. This is extremely tough.
And that jump is so hard to anti-air, so hard to deal with.
See, and now Kevl knows that he has RM Cloud condition. He's not going for any rolls early on. We might see a few here and there, but he's perfectly content saving his meter at this point.
And we haven't seen one even chance or one attempt from Cloud to armor out.
And because he knows he wants to save his meter for Breaker, but he's getting clipped by every mix-up in the book right now. Kevl is just suffocating Cloud.
Oh. No room to breathe. And, you know, it looks like Cloud's just content on taking it.
And it's hard. It's really hard to say. There we go. Finally getting something started there. Spending the bar to put him in the restab. What will be Cloud's next move? Very nice read by Kevl the Man. Just want to get in immediately.
There we go.
Read it, but didn't trust his own read. RM Cloud making full advantage of it.
And
jumping out of it.
What a read by Kevl back, just jumping for it, where as if Shinnok had done his forward four, it definitely would have clipped that.
Now, are we going to see something to close out the second round? The next touch will do it. And there it is. That's it. That's game.
And
that's it. Everett Alvarez getting hyped for his boy.
Back-to-back matches have just been so fast.
This is rough.
Here we go.
I have to reset Mystic. He's going Mystic.
This is what it's all about.
I think I've seen this character once or twice before.
Maybe even three times.
He's making me happy. He's making Toxin happy. I know he's out there somewhere looking at Toxin. I know if you're watching, this is what we need to see. Now, this could play off very well for him. He has the ability for full screen to keep her away. But being able to just throw out your meter if he blocks it, if you're off your meter against Melina,
yes,
it is absolutely a wrap. But this is what we like to see. We're seeing a lot more of these Ermacs come out of the woodwork. Hopefully making a name. Now, armor breaking is much harder to do against him. A full combo punish, opting to break. Very smart, but Kevl the Man. That Cloud already showing way more. Not jump.
What an anti-air there by Kevl. Whereas most Molina's looks go for the roll, but having the confidence to go for your down one against the Ermax jump two.
The jump two is an extremely good, very bad read on there. Kevl capitalizing, very smart by him to just stay patient knowing that Cloud was going to go for it.
And here we go, match point. Just like that. I thought we were just commentating the first round.
No, this is going faster than we even anticipated. But Cloud is not out of this just yet. He's been doing much better up against Melina.
Misses one big opportunity here. And that may cost him this entire match.
Now, he's going to be sitting on a breaker in a second here. Decides to spend the bar, keep himself out of the corner. Bill Samira, down one lift.
If this was Injustice, folks, that would have worked.
And Cloud is on his last legs. And the clip, the breaker, the last legs,
and
the miracle that didn't happen.
We've all seen that before from our Mag players, ladies and gentlemen, but Kevl the Man looking very comfortable there. Really was just in Cloud's mind the entire time.
Kevl extremely happy. Cloud being sent to lose his first round.
And the crowd is into it.
The crowd
They're loving
Deborah
it.
Hours rallying
Everett rallying up. Yeah. But yeah, as I was saying, Kevl is here representing Hazardous Gaming. So is Dark. Dark got picked up by them. And there's a couple other Virginia guys in there. They're representing Hazardous Gaming, and they're going to make a statement.
Good.
I guarantee it.
I'm ready to see. Is Hazardous a local organization?
I couldn't tell you. Maybe.
Because I personally have not heard of it. And you know what? And that's what I kind of like. Even now, like, looking at Saltface seeing No Surrender, I have not personally heard of these guys, but at the same time, I
have
seen
back
all
in the
these
day.
Organizations coming into it like this. You know?
I seen No Surrender back in the first Season 1 KI days. That was the last time I heard of No Surrender.
You know what? Now that you're saying that, I actually do remember something like that.
Nikki NS, Ginty NS.
That's where I heard it from. Now, but Nikki moved on to Circa,
yep.
I believe.
And,
he's here this weekend. Yep. I think Nikki is here this weekend, so I'm really excited to see him because KI is so.
I love KI, man.
I love watching it, man.
I was
too hype.
I was a huge KI player until the Season 2 changes, and then I was like,
yeah, you know what? It's just I can't really get used to the game. I get body when I play it, but I'll watch that game any day of the week.
That's like Soul Calibur with me. I love watching Soul Calibur, but I am not.
Ah, so up next.
I'm not good.
Our very own brother from another mother. We have KP, the one and only. This is no bunch. Like, they're going right into it.
They're going in raw?
They're going in raw. I can't do this, man. Don't do this to me, please. Don't do this. No bunch checks. This
is
it.
Jima Ninja.
I'm calling him Jay. I'm sorry, but I am calling you Jay, sir. So we have KP going up against Jay. Ooh, dive kick. Sorry, not now. He's going to go for the covert ops. Sonya, the mix. Going for a low, nice block, but doesn't go for the full combo punish.
Yeah, that was. It's gonna take. It always takes a second when you haven't played covert ops in a while to remember everything.
You know, and even then, when you get conditioned to it, it is very hard when you're in the corner.
When you block that low, it is your time to shine.
Stands for days. 4-1-1 down 3. Such a good tool.
And Katana Prime by far the best Katana I've ever seen. Tech wise, combo wise, everything
wise. Katana specialist alongside Atai, the only two left in the business.
Yeah.
I would say, KP, just really just putting in work, keeping that space control, trying to get JX Max Ninja to get impatient.
GXR MBB GH Max Ninja, you need to calm down and correct his name, sir.
Excuse me. Well, at the beginning, it was nothing more than a keyboard input into the put spaces in that name.
Shout out to Shock for the fix on his three sponsors.
Really just keeping the space. You know what? But Ninja's still keeping composure. Oh. But KP is so good at knowing when to run in with those grabs to throw him off his timing.
That's a KP special right there. Run up throw. When you've got the conditioning with the fans, you're sitting there waiting.
He's going for it. He was going to go for the brutality. Max Ninja's going straight up into the second match. Now, Max Ninja had a good start. He put him in that mix, but the moment he got full screen, he got very impatient. Oh, getting opened up. Did he get that military
stance?
Military stance. Beautiful spacing by KP, getting that 4-1-1 punisher back.
Just a gorgeous jump in right there.
He just knows.
That's confidence right there. When you wake up, jump.
And you know this just as much as I do, man. When you get into the first match, you put the momentum in yourself for the rest of the day.
Absolutely.
It's your first match. What you need to make sure you win to keep that confidence and that momentum going
and
the rest of the day.
Very, very few do you see someone blow that string up in tournament like KP just did right there. That is character knowledge right there.
Oh, and here we go. Mix City. Max Ninja keeping KP his home. Oh. He's got to mix it up, man. He's going for the same stuff, and KP's smelling it a mile away. Trying to get something going. Lots of whips going. Katana Prime making the most out of it. Switching positions.
Ooh.
Trying to swag on him
He kind of messed himself up with that one.
Keeping those plus frames.
And I love the patience there. Throwing the EX fan, having the plus frames of backing off, kind of looking for the armor, and then going right back in.
Regardless of how these matches are going, he's respecting everything Ninja is able to do, even though Ninja hasn't done
it. And the EX Sharpen mid combo there to close out. That's all knowledge right there.
Styling, man. He wants to make a statement. This is his time to make the top 8, and he wants it. He won't settle for anything less.
He's been in a lot of top 16s, folks. A lot of them.
There we go. And here comes the mix.
What a
very
back dash.
Nice back dash and the whip punish.
That was amazing. That would have worked against the overhead and the grab, but not the low. There's no gap when she goes in the low.
You know, Max Ninja, there we go. Had to get KP off his meter. A very good moral victory. But then KP, just unrelenting pressure.
And he's smacking on him still.
There you go. And then assassin run to make sure he doesn't get himself put in the corner. Oh, very nice cross up, and here we go. One mix up, and that's it. You know what? And that's when you know you have your opponent conditioned, where he has a chance to do a 50-50 and decides to just sit there and block.
And respect the wake up.
KP seemed to have this man conditioned from every aspect. But Max is just not out of it yet. Just because he's down 2-0, it does not mean he's out. He's been doing surprisingly well. He has.
And you know, what I love about KP are all the little conversions. It's so fun to watch. Oh, here we go.
Oh my god, and the exit. This is going to do a lot of damage, actually. Even though it's not demolition, this is going to do a respectable 50%. 46%. Keeps it nice and short.
Oh, just an entire stand one half screen.
Oh
just,
my god.
Just, you know, because he's feeling himself.
Just trying to do it, and you know what? He's become so much better. Oh, he goes for the sharpen instead.
Oh, yeah.
Now, you know what?
Does
KP's
he want X-ray?
Ready.
He wants
do you
X-ray.
See at that back left corner? You know it's coming. He's going to save it.
Oh, wow. Nope.
He's going for it. He doesn't want to take any chances. Now, this will not kill. Drops a combo anyway. Is he going to break?
Now, Max Ninja could have just ran more after the cartwheel and got it back into the corner. Down two? Oh, no.
And he gets clipped anyway. Oh, no. Ninja's so close.
Is he going to go for brutal?
How long?
Oh my gosh.
Unbelievable swag as he walks off.
And right there, that was the perfect opportunity with Sony's down two to just anti-air KP, close out that round, and just move on, having a little bit of momentum.
It was so smart.
Just didn't have the reaction or the...
Jeez, man. You know what? And KP is playing super on point, feeling good, good start to his day, and that's what he needs.
And this is going
to
be good for him in his bracket.
It's good. Eventually, he will be going up against Solface. I'm not sure how quickly or later.
KP with confidence is a scary dude. And, you know, the history proves that the further he gets, that the kind of lower his confidence gets. Against top players, he goes in with a negative mentality of it being a bad matchup. I've seen it happen so many times against Illusions where it'll be Blood God, and he's just already mentally shot. I think if he overcomes that...
That's one of the things, and especially, it's definitely one of the advices I give to everyone who, you know, wants to come out and compete. Do not play with your emotions.
Yeah.
You play with your reads and your reactions. The moment you let your emotions affect your gameplay, you've already lost. And it's a serious problem for a lot of players. But KP's one of the advocates of working on that. So hopefully we'll be seeing him again on stream shortly, I'm sure.
Absolutely.
But we're going to go ahead and get with some more matches going up in just a minute.
But you know, he's always been the guy to kind of put his emotions on his shoulders. And
yeah, he definitely wears his heart on his sleeve, which is, you know, it's people love him for that. You know, he's definitely one of the realest people in the community. We know that.
Absolutely.
As long as it doesn't affect his gameplay, you know. So now, as we're getting up with that,
he's actually going to play an off-stream match, I believe. Off-stream, I see Gurr playing still. No brows. That actually might be casuals.
Yeah, those are going. Gurr already finished his pull. He was playing earlier. Unfortunately, he was eliminated.
Those are all casuals then. He didn't make it out. I know it was him, Killtron. I think that was also the Illusions pool.
Yeah. So it was, I believe.
Losers making out losers?
Emperor. No. The Duelist who can't play.
Yeah. Forever Lee.
Forever Lee. It was Forever Lee and winners, and then Illusions.
Illusions
and
losers.
But I believe he made top 32, which is really good for still, like a tournament like this.
Absolutely.
This tournament is not easy. Like,
I'll tell you what, guys. I've been to a lot of tournaments in the past couple of years for MKX. And Jason CEO was by far the hardest I'd ever seen, because that I had been to. And this is the second. When I looked at all the pools, I saw about two killers per pool, and I went, "Oh no, oh no!"
Every single pool, no pool here is.
Whereas most tournaments I went to before, it's probably one killer per pool. I was like, okay, but oh man, and CEO had about three per pool, which was just disgusting.
These names are 100% mixed up.
And here we go.
Hey, Shock, switch the names.
Unless Saltface is breaking out.
There's no way. But you know what? Unstoppable Jason and Pools? Come on, man. That's sick. Oh, don't tell me you're playing with my heart. Don't you dare go Molina. Now he's going Jason.
Are we seeing a Jason mirror?
No way.
Oh, yes. What are the odds?
Hold up. Let's go, This is going to be the quietest match ever because none of them have any sounds when they get hit.
It's just going to be, well, is there a slasher? Yeah. We're going to hear a machete slicing somebody up.
Now Saltface does play machetes.
Machete. Fight. It actually might be switched.
Might be switched again, actually.
Yep.
Yeah, they switched
it. Yep.
Yeah, so we have Saltface going with Slasher Jason, who he's been working on for a very long time now. Oh, max damage.
Hello.
Oh, just drops a down one choke.
Look at the hitbox. That was disgusting.
Oh, now he's definitely not going to come back. Now, the biggest thing with Slasher, outside of his safe 50-50s in the corner, he does ridiculous damage.
Very.
Look how quick
meterless.
That first round was. Meterless damage, yeah.
And a mid projectile that is so fast, it has no recovery. And his back one there covers so much ground, safe on block.
Nine frame mid that goes almost sweep range. Very good tools. And who better than to showcase these tools than Saltface? Now, Beaks is just trying to get something going with Unstoppable. But Saltface has the full screen presence. He has the up close game on lockdown. There's not a lot that Beaks can really do. He's going to come back here, but I don't really see anything working out for him.
Yeah, he would need to open him up, get into the corner, and dodge that wake up armor.
And there you go. He's going for the brutality. Are we going to see it? Fight through the neck. Oh, it's so nasty,
it's
man.
It's so brutal.
It really is. Between Jason and Leatherface, I have the best brutals in the game. Free.
Oh, the hammer one. Can we talk about the hammer?
That shit goes off. It goes off for like 15 seconds.
It's 80 seconds of pure Mortal Kombat at its best.
Oh,
look
my
at
God,
the hitboxes.
Getting flipped by the last hit of the back 2-2. Back 1-2-2. And here comes safe 50-50s. Oh, keeping it simple. Quick stand.
Yep, nice little quick stand there. And this is stuff I've never seen from Slasher Jason.
And Saltface, you know what? Beaks only got hit twice, and look at his health. And just going for it. Beaks not going to come back. He's coming back.
He believes.
He believes with no meter. He's coming back.
5% later. Oh, if he'd have done a jump two, I believe.
Now, the command grabs are still in play. And there you go. Back 1-2-2. Saltface just all over this guy. Beaks is having a really tough time.
Like I said, this is a variation that even if I were to go into, I'd go, what is he doing to me? And you have to adjust really quick.
Finally getting the buffs going on, trying to get some health and meter in there. But this is it. With Unstoppable not getting that teleport, it's very hard full screen. There you go. This is going to do a lot of damage. Look at that. Meterless 39%.
And that's off an air. Oh, my gosh. It was
that
plus.
Is plus. Oh, tried to get him with the gut stab. Still going to do it. Breaks before he has a chance to come alive. Now, if and when he goes down this round, he has no meter.
And this is one machete from death already.
Is he going to do it? He's probably just going to machete. Throw the machete. There you go. Expected the command grab. Oh, whiffed it. Wait, brutal? Brutal boys. Come on, man.
And there we go.
Yes.
Two in a row. Can we get a three-peat?
Oh, I think at this point, Beaks is just a little bit lost in this. Even Outworld's just throwing up his hands. This is just an absolute massacre. Now, do you have the stream? I want to see the brackets for what's going on. Maybe when the shot gets back, I want to go ahead and check that out. Saltface, you know, the good thing is Beaks is still not getting opened up by 50-50s, but the spacing is what's really killing him. And Saltface has one of the best fundamentals in the game right now. Going ahead with the command grab. Beaks really trying to make something work, but Saltface never putting himself into a bad position. Back three into just trying to get something started. Nothing's happening. Saltface just all over him. Now, will Beaks come back? Beaks is going to save his meter. At this point, he really does need a miracle. Really hasn't been able to get too much of anything going. He's really content just keeping his stream. Grabs him. Very nice. Got those switch positions on him. Oh, very nice wake up because that quick stand does a lot of damage. That back one stagger, even though it's negative 11, oh my god. That's it.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, right in the stomach.
It is not over.
You're right, it's not. Now, if Beaks can make something happen,
this is our chance for the three-peat.
And that's it. Who? The swag. Oh my god. 39% meterless.
I have never seen Jason do these things.
Look at, listen, the most silent fatality.
And there we go, guys.
What is that? I love it. I love it so much. Paying tribute to the classic horror movies. I love it. That was some serious slasher work, man. I hope we keep seeing that.
That was, they said, and I've been around a while. I've never seen Jason stuff like that before.
Honestly, but you don't see slasher like that anymore.
Yeah.
You really, really don't.
I've seen the Unstoppables, you know, all your standard stuff, the back 1-2-2s.
Right.
Big boot, whiff, big boot, down one.
You don't see these lows in the temple charges for 50-50s yeah. and the 40%. You don't see stuff like
get
that.
Get an air-to-air, and then you get three strings and 39's gone. And you're like, what just happened?
Now the question is, will Saulface continue with slasher Jason throughout the rest of the pools?
If and when he runs into Katana Prime.
That's what I'm looking forward to. That's going to be interesting. Now, at the end of the day, Saulface wants a top eight.
How much slasher experience does KP have in him?
I don't know.
You play slasher? My statement remains.
Wow. I was like, wait, was that a compliment? I was like, wait, there is no way that's a compliment. You just blew me up low key.
Buffalo in conflict?
Do you have the bracket? Let me take a look at the bracket. Okay, let me see, because I want to see who we could get next on stream. We got some...
We got a big one coming up right now.
Yeah, we have Conflict 90 going up against Buffalo, who is one of the renowned Sub-Zero players. You're on stream.
I'm trying to get these names right.
Predator.
We have a match.
Reach the keyboard.
All right, so we have Buffalo's own Buffalo going up against Florida's own Conflict 90. Now, Buffalo is a Grandmaster Sub-Zero main through and through, and Conflict is...
hot off the press?
Yes, thank you very much. Conflict is a HUT Predator, and he plays Summoner Quan as a little bit of a heavy weapons Jax.
That's how you play Slash.
Man, Saulface is just looking for props, man. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and take a look at these pools. We'll have Conflict and Buffalo. This is still winner's side. This is still winner's side. The winner of this will go on to the semifinals of the pool to play the winner of Kevo and Hazard Blank. That can't be right. It's Hazard Kevo.
It is Hazard Kevo. No, it's Hazard Blank.
Is it really Hazard Blank?
Yeah.
Okay, I like it. So then we're going to have a team kill pretty much. They're both Hazard is...
We are, because Hazard is Kevo.
Okay.
And Buffalo... Yeah, I mean, the winner of this makes it the winner's finals.
All right, cool. So here we go.
Conflict
90 going up against Buffalo right now. Yeah. Conflict is on the right. Buffalo is on the left.
Buffalo rocking a... Is he old enough to know where that comes from?
I don't know. He looks very young. There's no way.
Did he watch Ninja Turtles growing up?
There's no way.
Does he know?
That was in my childhood.
Does he know the tech?
Hey, let me see. Next up, I want this up next. If that's up next, and then let me see when you run through losers.
And Buffalo, the infamous mirror with Brady.
At Evo, yes. I unfortunately didn't get to see it, but I heard about it.
That's why Buffalo should be a household name to everybody.
Player one is Conflict, and then Buffalo is in the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles here. All right, so.
If he did grow up on that, good on his parents.
Now, Conflict does have a few characters under his sleeves. If I was a betting man.
Predator, you think?
Predator, for sure.
Yep.
Now, Buffalo decided to lock himself in the Sector, so maybe he knows what Conflict's characters are, because I do believe that Sector does well against HQT. On yes. a read, you could literally teleport HQT's missiles.
Yep.
And so that will create a problem.
This will be our first time really seeing guys already going in with a mind game.
Yeah. Now, I'm not sure if this is a button check. Yeah, this is going to be a button check real quick.
Now, Conflict 90 has a very impressive Predator. I would say relatively close to Destroyers. Not on that level just yet. I play with this guy all the time. He's a personal training partner of mine. He puts in the work with his character all the time. And Buffalo is definitely a renowned player.
Here we go.
Round number one. Going for the neutral jump punch to start it off.
And Buffalo already looked like he knew what Conflict was going to do.
And you know what? And Buffalo's making the right reads right now. This is exactly where he wants to be because HQT can't really do much full screen. It was a very smart pick. Spending two bars, very nice.
And I think you really did nail it with that. Buffalo went in knowing what Conflict would do.
This was very smart. By the he made the read at the character select screen. Very smart.
And he's already shown the confidence and the character matchup knowledge. The moment that he saw a smart disc teleport, it's already on display here.
Yeah. And you know what? And this is showing good matchup knowledge on Buffalo's part. Just because he knew it was Predator, he knew Sector was the right choice. And he knew what to do with Sector. That's knowing what character to pick is only half the battle.
And not only character knowledge, but player knowledge, which is even harder. To know everyone's going to show up to the tournament, who they use, what they're thinking, it takes time.
Oh, very nice 1-1-1 out of that pressure there. Very nice bait on the armor as well. Buffalo just seeming to be in Conflict's head right now. Nice tech. Buffalo is ready for everything, and he's really kind of putting Conflict in a weird spot. This early in a set, you don't want to be second-guessing yourself. Very nice cancel. Into a hit confirm. And here comes the mix.
Just watch out for flamethrower, and that's actually going to chip out.
And that's going to do it. Buffalo taking the first game convincingly. Conflict going straight into Predator.
And this is really good Sector play. Really, the only Sector we've seen is really Costner.
Yeah. Who is here, too, and I'm really excited to see him.
That guy is too good.
Come off 17th at Evo.
And that's not easy to do. He's about some big names as well, but Buffalo is just... He's really just making all the right user now. There's really no other way to put this. Oh, the read was there, but the space was just short.
And all this chip damage, he built up half a bar doing that.
There you go. Very nice punish by Conflict. He didn't put himself on the board with some good damage. Hard knockdown into the smart hit. Oh, very nice damage. Nice grab.
And Conflict turning things around right here, right now.
You know, he knew what he was doing. Just has to be careful with flamethrower. He's going to hurt. He's going to off the pick here.
Oh no.
He's going to get one more mix. He's going to do it. And he doesn't block the overhead.
God. Conflict.
Buffalo letting off a little bit of a pop off there.
He fell apart there. Conflict had that in the bag. And now all it does is it just adds fuel to the flame that is Buffalo right now.
That was not a pun. Please tell me that wasn't a pun.
It wasn't intended, but now that you say that.
Oh, my God. I can't be with this man anymore.
I did not intend that pun, ladies and gentlemen.
Of course you didn't. Moving on. EX flamethrower for the burn. Just fading it out every time. Conflict playing extremely impatient. And Buffalo's picking up on it. Conflict needs to go to players like,
and
take some time to think about it.
Take some time and may go to his main.
His main main. Tribal. He's going back to Sector. Conflict needs to take a second. Think about it. He has a few other characters in his book.
Quan may not be a terrible pick, especially Sorcerer.
Yeah, Sorcerer is the main one that he has been working on.
Yep, and here
we go. Go ahead with Sorcerer. I agree with this because at the end of the day, HUT, you know, he plays it pretty well, but he just seems completely lost in the matchup. And when you're down 2-0 like this, you have to do what you can to really make something happen. So he's still in this, that's the thing. He has a chance to make this back in and go for a little bit more set play. Back three teleport, just like that Buffalo starting it off early. Overhead teleport, he's literally just mixing Conflict right now. Wow, the EX trance, what a hard read. Are you gonna set up the portal? I like how we dash a little bit. He wants to put him a little bit more towards the front. He has the hit on armor. Oh, tried to get the neutral jump punch. Doesn't come out of time.
That was hard to deal with because that string is so negative on its own. And 1-1 from Sector there is a pretty quick double hitting string.
Well, misses the on the portal. That's going to hurt. You cannot back that set. Buffalo is having great spacing. Huh? Alright, so we just got where Kevo did play his next match off screen. Kevo did take it. KP, what was the score? So we don't know the score, but Kevo did end up taking it.
And here we go, this is where conflict get things wrong, because he's gonna get another portal in out the corner, which is where Quan Chi is just devastating in Sorcerer.
Now he's still gonna have that. Oh, and he didn't get the armor time, but it's gonna make
here.
A drop. There you go.
But Buffalo just still relentless in his pressure, which is really how you should approach it. Don't let Quan Chi kinda dance around you with that portal.
And he goes for the trance. This is gonna do a lot of damage. He just gave himself. Got rid of the life lead in the corner. On his last legs, can he make something happen quickly? Goes for the plus frames. Wait
that
a minute!
Crouched it, which is how exactly you're supposed to deal with that.
Oh no! And that's it. And he gets chipped out just like
chip.
That.
And Buffalo with the teabag there at the end.
Savagery. Buffalo taking it 3-0 over Conflict. Semi-Conflict to losers.
Conflict really took the risk there at the end to, rather than go for the max damage combo, get the hard knockdown full screen to go for another 50-50 to really close it out.
And he had the right idea at that point. The read was there. The mix-up was there. The execution wasn't. Unfortunately, he really just couldn't make it happen. Is it to say that he should have went Sorcerer Chrom from the beginning? Maybe. But he had the right read, did the hit and select, but Buffalo just smelled it out.
And what was odd is that you put yourself in that situation where you've already made the mental decision to go for a reset rather than the full combo and not commit, you know?
It's true. And he went for the plus frames, which was the right idea. At that point, when you're down in life but the opponent doesn't have breaker, at that point, you just got to put some faith in yourself in the read that you're going to make, whether it's going to be overhead or low. And the read was there, but maybe he wasn't expecting it to actually work, and the combo just ended up dropping, unfortunately.
And then he backdashed rather than back two, which may have been input error, but I think it was just a mental thing.
But you know what? For Buffalo to take the set 3-0 without using Sub-Zero, it's a very strong statement that he could potentially go very far in this tournament. Sector for the matchups that he doesn't like with Grandmaster could take him a very long way.
And just going through who kind of bullies Sector, who bullies Sub-Zero, it seems like a good pick.
I'm going to have to agree. I personally didn't even know he had a Sector.
Yeah, I mean, I'm with you on that one.
This is going to be good. Now, this is a Lash of Takeda from, obviously, Buffalo, if you could see the jersey from there, going up against KP. Lasher against Katana. KP is opting to go with Assassin, no doubt, for the parry against Lasher.
I remember at the Buffalo tournament.
He caused an upset and beat Honeybee.
That was it. Yeah, because I was going to say, I remember a Lasher Takeda from that tournament. Newbie.
That's who. Yeah, you're right. You're right. All right, so. Now, Newbie is not someone to take lightly. This guy is a force to be reckoned with.
And this is a variation very likely seen. It has his range is outstanding. His jump back two, the range he possesses with his whips. He's a really good character.
And the down 4-1, that long-ranging poke is so
look at
right
that
there.
Thing. And the jump back one, I believe it is so hard to deal with when you're a character that doesn't have long range.
Right. There you go. All right. Now KP trying to get some big damage in here. Not dropping it. Hard knockdown. What?
What just happened?
What was that?
We don't know. The gods don't know.
EXDP to make something happen. The buff is still there. This is going to do some serious damage. Lucha jump punch into the hard knockdown. Both has a bar meter.
And wow, what a
bait. And he goes for the armor. Newbie clutching out the first round. Very smart stuff.
I respect Newbie there for not waking up or pressing a button. Because he can hold that parry.
Very nice. You know what? KP was waiting for that back two. A jump punch in a back two is not real. You can punish that with a poke.
Yes, you can.
If you're in the right range. But KP just is showing this ridiculous corner pressure right now, not letting Newbie breathe to make sure that he doesn't go within that space.
And right now, looking at the health for Newbie, this is really all about building meter. I wouldn't spend meter here on combos. Yep, I keep it nice and simple.
Wow, very nice read by Newbie. And the EXDP by KP. Going to close out this second round.
I would be very happy as Newbie right now because I got Katana Prime to come off a bar meter, and I built the bar in the process. Going into round three.
And you know what? I respect the fact that KP went for unbreakable damage and tried to build just a little bit more meter. He had a good enough life lead to believe in himself that Newbie was going to get that big, you know, comeback. So just playing the full screen game.
Ooh.
Goes for it anyway. The assassin run paying off for KP. Back one stagger. Beautiful stuff. Newbie doesn't have enough meter to break, but is sitting on a bar to be able to get out of that corner if he chooses to. And there it is, forcing KP to break. Moral victory in itself.
And I like seeing from Newbie the risk that he's trying to take to get out of that corner.
Now, this is the range and the position that Newbie wants to be at. Lasher does a very good amount of damage in the corner. Oh. The wake-up grab by KP to switch positions. Newbie having one bar meter, unpunishable.
Wake-up throw is one of the most savage things a man can do in MKX.
And KP knows exactly when to do it. Newbie just sitting on his last leg, and there you go, KP.
What a comeback from KP there. That was a great adjustment. And right there, at the start of round two, you saw him jump over, and that's one of Lasher Decay's weaknesses, or really all Decay's weaknesses, it was when they whiffed that giant back two, I believe it's called back two, that it whiffs forever.
Very nice defense by Katana Prime.
If you're able to jump it.
Which is really hard to do.
Oh, here we go. Some swagger from Katana Prime.
KP's getting into the swing of things. The crowd is winding up to watch this set. Tries to open him up with the back two. Doesn't work. Newbie responding with some pressure of his own. Hard knockdown. Back two two mix up. Here comes all of the mix. And the EXDP getting rid of that pressure once and for all.
That's twice that's paid off for KP, just the raw DP mid-pressure.
He just seems to know, and you know what? And I think it's because one of the worst things you could do is overthink your opponent. He's doing it until he realized that Newbie is going to respect it and wait. Here we go, some decent damage into here. Hard knockdown. There you go. Gets opened up, finally. Newbie getting some good damage in there, 32%. And the mix is all there for him. 4-1-2 stagger into the grab.
And at any moment, a low kunai could be coming. And, oh.
And that was just absolutely dominating. You want to talk about suffocating mix-ups like that. That was, Newbie, that was like a whole new player right there.
That was, oh my gosh.
That was a great read to keep himself out of the corner.
That's three that have just been really ballsy by KP that have paid off so far.
Oh, doesn't get the hit confirm. Great blocks by Newbie, trying to make something work.
There's that jump back two, or one, that's so hard to deal with.
There you go, had to break. Wanted to keep Newbie as close to the corner as possible. Newbie not sitting on any meter.
And that was an instant air fan if I've ever seen one.
And you see, and KP is starting to realize that he has Newbie conditioned. Newbie took a step back after knocking him down because he saw KP had that bar for the EXDP. Oh, very nice fan just catching him off there. Newbie still trying to work his way in.
If he hadn't thrown that fan, he would have caught him with that string.
And there's a parry just holding on to it. 21%.
That's going to do it.
And there you go. Is he going to go? He's going for the brutality. And Newbie wants there, no maybe, part
yeah,
of it.
Absolutely not.
Now, does Newbie have any other characters?
From my experience with Takeda players, their secondaries and thirdsies are the other variations of Takeda.
We saw Ethereal. Did we not just see Ethereal, or am I crazy? No, she has a size.
You're definitely crazy.
Yeah, I'm definitely crazy. That much I know. I know I'm crazy. That would have been hype to see Ethereal. And you know what? And if you look at it from a theory fighting point of view,
yeah,
Ethereal's not a terrible choice for this matchup.
Now,
it is Ethereal. You're crazy, man.
Let's be serious. I am crazy. But this is kind of what we saw in Injustice, where against Zoners that. Meterbird teleport against Zoners is so effective.
All right, so now Melina, the bane of everyone's existence, doesn't go for the punish on the DP. Is it Ethereal or Ethereal?
I've always heard it Ethereal.
Ethereal? I think I'm getting blown up. I don't know.
We can get blown up. It's okay.
Hey, is it Ethereal or Ethereal? Ethereal. It is ethereal. Everyone needs to leave. You heard it from Saltface himself.
Saltface himself. So if we're all wrong, blow Saltface up.
Yeah. Blame Saltface. He plays the character. All right. So Newbie taking the first round.
Convincingly. But KP sitting on two paddles, really.
Oh, doesn't go for a ball roll as an anti-air. But KP dropping the combo, picking it back up with a neutral jump punch. And there we go. Just still going in there. Goes for the hard knockdown into the sharp and trying to get some big damage in there. Nice grab.
I'm curious if he didn't do the low, if he'd have done a high or a mid, if the parry would have worked behind her.
You know what? At this point, I wouldn't even be surprised.
I wouldn't be surprised. I'm really glad that he did a low, though.
Yeah, that was very good. And KP taking a round to adjust, but picking it back up where he left off. Sitting on set point to put Newbie into losers. Oh, just drops
twice.
The combo.
That's twice that he's tried that same exact conversion.
He needs to be careful. If Newbie goes up a game, he could get the momentum that he needs. Very nice read. He is pretty much 90% on with these EXDPs.
And the one that he blocks didn't go punished.
Just playing the spacing game now. Newbie sitting on a good amount of bar. Building some more meter just in case he gets clipped. And there it is. EX roll. Getting something started. Goes for the Oki. And one mix-up is going to do it either way. Newbie trying to make something happening. On his last leg, KP does have two bars for a breaker. Will we see a DP to close it out? And the EX Assassin run. And there it is. KP taking out Newbie 3-0. Trying to do fatality. What a noob.
And he missed it.
And he missed it entirely.
Anytime you see like a norm, like him shimmy and then jump, it's a missed fatality.
So that was impressive on both ends. You know what?
Yeah,
Newbie still played very great with Lasher and Molina. You know, he was trying to throw KP off. But KP's defense is just on point right now.
And except the reads, but being about 90% on the reads is, whoo, you're going to win.
I'm, you know what? And at the end of the day, Newbie still got some of those mix-ups off. So the momentum could have shifted, but KP just maintained composure.
Yeah, I just saw the one round where he just put him in the corner and bullied him to death.
Now, as we move closer and closer and closer.
Oh, here we go. We got Buffalo versus Kevo the Man.
I do believe.
That's one of the finals of this pool.
Candyman. Is this winner's finals?
This one, yeah.
Winner's finals? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So we have Buffalo versus Kevo the Man, Hazard Kevo the Man, in winner's finals for pool number 3.
And
this is going to be interesting.
This is a. He might go sector in this one, too.
Oh, I strongly advise he goes sector.
And there's a few reasons. Not only because of it just being a better matchup on paper, but because we saw Cosner versus Kevo the Man at Defending North, 2-3, down to the last round. So we've seen sector do decent against Kevo's Molina already.
And at this point, even if sector didn't do well against Kevo in the past, Sub-Zero is such a tough pick against Molina. I think we can all agree on that at this point. So Buffalo, having a pocket character as solid as what we've just seen, there's no reason he wouldn't at least try Sector first. But we'll have to wait and see. Now, he is highlighting Sub-Zero, but he is player 2. He starts off with Sub-Zero. I wouldn't advise, but you know what? Maybe he's working on it. He's working on something. He knows something we don't. Starting off with his best foot forward, I can't be mad at that. I just can't be mad at that.
And you know, he just might be confident in that matchup. I've been confident in losing matchups before, and it's paid off.
And you know what? There's no telling what he has in store for us. You know, when you have a bad matchup like this, you lab it to find a way.
Absolutely. My personal pick for Shinnok with Kotal-kan is Blood God, which on paper is the worst pick you should ever do.
Right.
But it's just something that I'm comfortable with, and this may be something he's comfortable with.
Now, Buffalo just made sure.
Or he's going to go to character select and pick sector. Oh, no, we're going in.
He had to go with it. He's going to stick with it. We'll have to wait and see what happens. Can he pull an upset? Very nice space by Kevo the Man with the forward 2-1. Keeping him standing there. Buffalo sitting full screen.
Oh, came off the bar. This is not good for Buffalo.
You know what? And this is smart for Kevo, first off, to not go for any EX rolls. He knows he doesn't need to play crazy to take out Sub-Zero.
That was kind of a
I think that he was expecting the back 1-2 to connect and decided to make a read for the hit confirm. I'm not too sure.
That's what's if there's one thing that I like about Molina is that you it's incredibly hard to hit confirm and if not impossible 4-1-2 in a row.
And Kevin the man breaking that ice cone right before Buffalo had a chance to throw it.
Sorry, back 1-2 in the roll.
There we go. Back 1-2 ice ball. Going to go ahead and switch positions. Kevin opts to break. Getting back 1-2 in there. Nice hit confirm. Now it did trade in his favor. Buffalo putting Kevin in the corner with no meter. This is where he wants to be. Oh, doesn't get the wasn't in the right distance for it. Goes for the 2-1. And this is going to do some good damage into the hard knockdown, into the clone setup. We'll see what Kevo decides to do to get out of this. Very nice read by Buffalo. Going ahead and take round number 2. Wow.
He came off all of his meter, so he's not in a great situation, but to get around and get some momentum, it's worth every bar meter, really.
Very nice back one stagger into the hit confirm. Now, Kevo's not going for the... Wow, that was a really nice ice ball trade. Kevo's not going for the special restand, the extra down on 2 for the most damage. So yeah. I'm wondering what he knows that we don't. It seems that he's just not opting to go for it.
Knowing Kevo, it's something.
It is. It has to be something because there's no way he would just miss execution like that. Wow, the neutral jump punch. Buffalo on his last legs needs to make something happen. Goes for the EX slide just on his last effort. So Kevo goes up 1-0, but you know what? That was not that bad for Buffalo.
Absolutely not.
Buffalo taking a second.
Once he got him cornered, once he got playing Sub-Zero's game, he looked very comfortable. But Kevo there, he got out two of the three times he got him cornered. So that's what it really may depend on if he decides to rematch here.
I think Buffalo's starting to realize that when he had Kevo in the corner with no meter, the round was his.
Yes.
He just had to be... Wow.
Great conversion here. But what he didn't really do was just throw a mix-up. He was doing down 4.
Armor-breaking clone working as intended.
And usually that actually hits. They would fall after that string under the clone. I'm not too sure what happened there.
And I see it. Buffalo knows that because Molina has a small hitbox, he's going for different combos to make sure that they still connect. Just taking his time.
And there we go.
Wow, Kevo opting to break. Wow, that puts Buffalo in a great position. He has Kevo off of his meter in the corner. I would expect if I was Buffalo for Kevo to do something crazy to get out of the corner.
This is what gets top players going, is when you see someone break right before the end of a round, and then you take the round.
Wow, the 1-2 stuffs the normal ball roll. And just like we were talking about, in the corner is very tough. 1-1 in the ice ball, keeping it simple for the hitbox. Kevo needs to make something happen to get out of this.
Backdashes!
Buffalo working on a flawless. And
if you would have canceled 4-4 in the ice blast, that would have been it.
That was insanely dominant. That was a completely different Buffalo from what we saw the first match.
And you know, I got a hand to him. His name is Buffalo. Is he from Buffalo, New York?
I'm going to pretend that he is because that just sounds
Let's
better.
Let's pretend that
it
he is from Buffalo,
better.
New York. The land of the tundra. The frozen men.
I love it. And this guy is looking like he is the grandmaster himself going against one of the hardest matchups.
And now we've got another good pick from Kevo here.
Now, Kevo, as we said before, he is known. He's almost like a forever king in the way. He has characters for different situations. And Buzzsaw has been known to do relatively well, but Buffalo is just absolutely on fire right now, reading it, going with the back 3-3 to EX, going for meter building. I love this guy. This is amazing.
This is who Kevo beat Brady with at one of my regionals, Top of the Food Chain.
Really?
Yes.
So he does know this matchup. There is some knowledge behind picking Buzzsaw, going for EX man just to get himself out of the corner. If he takes the round, great, but he really just wanted to get out of there. And the craziness will not work. Buffalo,
that was dominant.
This is going really well for Buffalo right now. He's treating these matchups perfectly. He takes his time. Very smart EX spin by Kevo.
That was a great reaction. That was all reaction right there.
He was waiting for it. And Kevo is a great player, so he knows when someone wants to be able to hit a button and react accordingly. He's going to let Buffalo know that he's not going to be bullied from this mid-screen. Because one of the biggest things with Sub-Zero players in general, you want to be able to establish dominance mid-screen because you know.
Oh my gosh.
And the mix.
Oh no.
The blender. Making pancakes. Jemima. Sponsored by Jemima. Kevin the man.
Three to the legs.
That was some insane mix that I just watched. But Buffalo getting Kevo off the meter. Kevo looking to get something going. Oh, very nice EX clone. Now, this is going to put Buffalo in a good spot. Kevo has the bar. And he goes for it right there. Does not want anything more to do with that corner.
Oh, my. Woke up with Chain Fist.
I'm so done.
That's something I've seen before, but not at this level.
Now you see Kevo has him conditioned with that EX spin ready to go for the bar. Oh, the tray working in his favor, sliding to get there just in time. Sitting on two bars, will he do something? Oh no.
Missed the throw. Oh!
Oh no, he blocked the first one.
And he let go. Oh no.
And there you go. Kevo going up game number three. It is now 2-1 in Kevo's favor.
What a risk from Kevo there, and it looked like Buffalo had the block and just let go.
Buffalo did have, and you know what? And I know what happened there because it happens to me all the time as well. You're so used to blocking Tempest, that's only one hit, so you let go to get ready to punish, you forget the two more that's coming. And here we go. Erin, is he thinking? Maybe. Now, here's the thing. As he picked Triborg, he had to understand, even if he wins this next match, Kevo will undoubtedly go back to Molina. Undoubtedly, there's no way he will stick with Buzzsaw, especially if Buffalo does really well. But we'll have to go ahead and wait and see. Trying to start off with something else. Now, I don't know how much history Kevo has with a sector.
I'm not too sure either.
So it could work out in Buffalo's favor, but he needs to be able to play very smart. Trying to bait the armor. Kevo waiting for the cross-up. Very nice. Oh, just getting stuffed there. And Buffalo's just getting, he's getting rushed down right now, and he doesn't really seem to know what to do.
That was very clean up from Kevo there.
Wow, it totally missed. The teleport missed.
And Kevo's in his head. When he does a stagger in the armor, it works.
And that is punishable. That flamethrower is negative 12. Buffalo is not looking good right now. Oh, the new jump punch connects. Here we go. Had to drop the combo just in the EX spin in general.
Neutral jump punch in the EX spin.
Now wait a minute. Do not count out Buffalo just yet. Sector does some good damage. That is full combo punish. Misses the punish. Wait a minute. He's going to get him off of his meter. No, he doesn't.
EX spin, and that's going to do it for the round.
And he just threw possibly that set away. If Buffalo takes this game.
But, to be fair, that's what got him game two.
That's very true. And here comes Buffalo, finally starting to shift momentum. After he's going on the brink of elimination, Buffalo's starting to make his way back.
And Kevo's living or dying by the sword right now. And he's living this moment.
Buffalo just trying to get out of this pressure. There he goes, just trying to make something happen there. Getting the traits, keeping them full screen with the plus frames. Goes for the interactable. There you go. Very smart move by Kevo. This is going down to the wire. The next hit should do it. Goes for the grab. Buffalo sitting on a bar. Will he use it? And Kevo the man using the EX spin.
That may have been chip either way.
And there you go. Kevo advancing on into winner's top 16. Buffalo not out of it just yet. Very strong showing.
What was that? Four of those games could have gone either way.
Yeah, it really could. After the first game, when Buffalo started to buckle down and realize what he needed to do, it really went down to the wire. I would have personally thought he should have stuck with Sub-Zero. He did perfectly fine. But you know what? He made it work with Sector as much as he could. And in the end, he just got mixed. Yep. He got mixed. He got out-read. So very smart. Great play.
All of the low hats that ever existed.
He got hit by a lot. Also, one of the biggest things, too, with those low hats, you got to be afraid of that EX spin coming afterwards. That's the hardest thing.
Because he gets that hat back immediately.
Now, that was winner's finals for pool number three. This is now pool number four, winner's finals. We have what we've been hyping up for a long time
is
now.
Is this it finally? We are finally in it, ladies and gentlemen.
EVB Katana Prime going up against Yomi RM Solface. Sponsored, apparently, by No Surrender Gaming.
Yomi RM NS Solface.
SF. Can we do that?
VVV.
VVV. VSM. KN. Man, I miss those days, too. Remember when Rio had like eight abbreviations? It was hilarious.
It was great.
Yeah, it was awesome.
Those were the days.
I miss VSM, man. All right, so now, as we noticed, as we expected, this is no button check. They're going straight into it right now.
And
Solface did not want to go Slasher Jason.
And
we have Katana Prime going with Assassin.
Did he pick Ethereal?
He did go Ethereal.
That looks like, yep. Yeah. Oh, piercing. Here we go.
Very interesting. Oh, and KP getting the first hit. Very nice jump over. But Melina almost on a full breaker. Going to be able to break the next time she gets opened up. There we go. KP going with the walk forward. Trying to shimmy him. Goes for the grab instead.
And Selfix looks, ooh.
Nice read.
Looks a little timid early.
And you know what? KP just wants to make sure that Solface stays in this corner because a piercing, dominates.
That was a wake-up roll that he's got through at him. Very good by KP.
And this is KP just locked down Solface.
Both of Solface's wake-ups there were stuffed. He tried a wake-up low side, which is a gimmick, but a very effective one when you're respecting overhead roll. And regular roll, which is hard to Oki itself.
Solface is... He's trying to make something work right here, trying to open him up right now. There you go. Back 1-2, low side into a grab. Switch positions. Hits him with the interactable. Very nice grab.
That looks like great character knowledge because that was tricky. That's something you have to know from playing Melina a lot.
Wow, and he jumped out of it knowing the low side is not a true block string. Will he be able to convert? Oh, just misses the input for the roll there. Solface trying to make something happen, building some meter. The more he blocks at that bar, meter alone, and there we go. That could take.
Oh, no.
Wait a minute. Beautiful tech. And now, Solface narrowly taking round number two, but putting himself in the corner in a very scary situation. Wow, standing on anti-air by Katana Prime.
Katana Prime's so good at that. And he always gets max conversions off all anti-airs. Down one, stand one.
Very nice EX roll, trying to make his way out of the corner slowly. The parry, holding it, letting Solface get hit by it with the back one.
Wake
nice
up, neutral NJP.
Jump punch. And the damage, 36%. These back one, wow, neutral ducking the grab and coming back with a grab of his own. There's that low side wake up you were talking about.
If you're respecting the EX roll, the EX low side is gonna hit you.
Instant air fan, gonna go for some unbreakable damage.
Unbreakable? What a double
two tag. Grabs in a row. Wait a minute. No, and just like that, Solface read it, taking the first game. KP not happy with the decision he made. Solface nodding his head, knowing he's slowly getting into KP's head.
And how those two tech throws, KP just, I think, mentally checked out.
You know what? After the two throws didn't work, KP didn't really know what to do. But he's staying composed.
You take a throw and you shimmy into a throw. I don't think I would have teched it, to be honest with you.
I wasn't ready for that.
I wasn't ready for it either.
That was a godlike tech. A beautiful play on Solface's part. And now Solface finally getting into the mix of things.
And he looks so much more comfortable right now. Yeah.
And you know what? He knows that KP's now playing on a tilt. KP's jumping in at him when you know you cannot jump in at Melina.
And Solface, they're going for damage rather than the restand that you see every other Melina go for.
And I respect it because you know what? He's opting to go for the armor breaking setups instead. He wants as much damage as possible because even if he gets clipped, he will have that meter to break. The instant neutral jump punch miss, going for KP to be able to trip guard.
Oh my gosh.
Just keeping some in. And you know what? Solface is doing very well here. He's just building meter. If he gets hit by the size, that's great. If not, he blocks it, and there you go. Forcing KP to break. Wasn't ready for that side to hit. Just this pressure is just so hard to deal with.
And at any moment, an EX low side could come, and then just more plus range.
And the hit confirmed. The down two for 25%. Molina sitting on an X-ray. Will he? And he goes for it.
Yes.
KP, going back to player select screen, needs to take a second and relax, because the first game was so solid, and the second game just seemed to be much tougher to deal with. He might... I don't recommend, me personally, Royal Storm cannot reflect the low size. It doesn't work.
Oh, man.
But he's opting, he's going with Mournful, which technically could work, but if he gets, if he goes in the air for that glaive,
and then a teleport,
and Saltface reads it, exactly, what's going to happen? He's going to get hit, and he's going to get knocked down into the armor breaking setup, so he needs to be careful when he's going to zone out Molina like this.
And Mournful does surprising damage for people that haven't seen the variation a whole lot. Once Mournful gets you to the corner, it's some big damage.
Oh, even mid-screen right now, you're looking at least 34% for every single combo. Very nice grab out of the 4-1 stagger. Now, KP has been in this position before where he's been down a couple games and managed to make it back. The only way to do that is to keep your composure, but Saltface is no stranger to tournaments himself. So it is very hard to put Saltface on tilt when he's up like this. We go back 1-2, staggering.
Great whiff punish there.
And he's going to go for it. Will KP? KP doesn't have stamina break, that's it.
Oh, no.
And Saltface going with the double down 2, whilst KP didn't have the stamina to break. Very smart.
And using what's probably the best footsie tool in the game right now. Leans back one. I can't believe that convert. That looked like it dropped.
KP trying to make something happen here. Saltface. Nice air-to-air by Saltface. Neutral jump punch. Going for max damage into the armor breaking. No, goes for the down 3. And here we go. Might be able to make something happen here. Now here comes that big damage we were talking about. 42% hard knockdown.
Went for a down 2 there. I'm not too sure how well Kitana does about low profiling that, but that's going to...
And that's going to do it. There's no... Oh, my God. I have never seen that.
She kicked her head off. She kicked her head off.
Oh, I've never seen that before in my life. Now, that was Winner's Finals. Saltface doing incredible work, making it in the top 16 winners. KP not happy. But this is not the last we've seen of him. Yes, we know this by now. He will be back. He will be ready to go.
He should make it out in losers. And we will definitely see him later at 10 o'clock tonight.
If he makes it out in losers, yeah. Top 16 to top 8 will be on the stream here at twitch.tv/combatnetwork at 10 p.m. Eastern, relatively, depending on what's going on with everything else. But later than 10.
And right now we are ahead of schedule. So
we are running ahead of schedule, which is great, because with the overflow gives chance people. Okay. Yeah, we're just going to run through. Now that the winners brackets are out of the way, we're going to go ahead and start streaming some losers side matches for you guys. We're still in pools 3 and 4.
And with your winners making it out, Kevo to man.
Saltface to my left. Yeah, so now for the top 16, as the per usual for before, we have in winner side so far, we have Circuit Destroyer taking pool number 1, I believe.
RM Forever Elite.
Now, we're not sure if they're going up against each other. The Mike Metroid, we're not sure if it's going to be 1 versus 2, 3 versus 4.
Or
it might be 1 versus 8.
1-8-2-7.
But before we get back into that, I want to give a quick shout-out, as always, to Dynamic Custom Beadworks. Those guys put in a ridiculous amount of work. They have some of the best products around. You saw before with that fake Charizard, that blue Charizard. They do all that stuff no matter what size you want.
With one of the best promo codes of the year.
Yeah. Make sure you use the promo code JWongIsFree for 25% off your next order. Follow them on Twitch, twitch.tv/dynamicbeadwork. Go check them out on all the social medias, facebook.com/dynamicbeadwork. And, of course, as always, at Twitter, at dynamicbeadwork, the number 1 in Perler Sprites.
And if you guys need anything, hit him up, tag them on Twitter. I had a guy this morning hit them up on Twitter. Bam. Hooked them up with an order right
I need to get an Ermac bead from these guys. I don't want the little ones that you normally get. I want to get one of those huge ones that hurts my neck when I wear it.
You want the Charizard-sized Ermac?
Yeah, even bigger. I don't even care because I want to be able to wear that on stream. That would be hype. Are you kidding? You see something that big? You're intimidated by that. That thing is bigger than your head. Come on, man. But make sure.
I had no idea this conversation was going to go to being intimidated by how large something would be. Okay?
And we're going to leave it at that because knowing our community, that would be taken the wrong way. So we're moving on into some loser side matches for you guys.
Right, here we got Clutch It Out, customized competitive apparel. These guys have awesome shirts. I've had my guy at my local Zappa buy a shirt that looks just like a sports logo with reptiles shooting an acid spit.
Sick.
It's absolutely wonderful. As you can see, that looks like Aaron Black doing a gunslinger thing, but I'm not too sure if that's Aaron Black or not.
I'm going to pretend that it is.
Yeah, why not? We've got Overwatch apparel. We've got that looks like Guilty Gear apparel. We've got the Frogger smacking someone in the mouth.
And the best part about it is that you can actually make your own item. You could put in a whole bunch of different logos or import your own and they'll put it on a t-shirt or whatever. So make sure to check it out. Any apparel, t-shirts, hats, whatever you feel like having, check it out at clutchitout.com.
Or come in person and see them at their table. They'll be more than glad to work with
you. Are they here
guys.
At this?
Are yes, they
here?
Are.
So guys, if you're stream monitoring and you're here this weekend at Summer Jam, do not miss that booth. I'm personally probably going to take a step back because I want to see if I could get, if they have some sort of MK t-shirt swag, I would love to have something like that.
Like I said, we saw one at Winter Brawl, and it was reptile outline shooting an acid spit with green and white, and it was so sexy.
Wow. I am seeing a variation I never thought I would see again. We have Kobu Tanya.
Wow. That is Kobu. That is... She... You remember that scene in Pirates of the Caribbean where the dude's like, you're supposed to be dead.
Tanya is supposed to be dead. We have not seen this character in forever. But here we are getting ready to see Lasher Takeda versus Kobu Tanya. I have not seen this. I'm waiting to see what the names are. We have Newbie, as always, who is a little bit misspelled, but we understand.
Sir Tommy Gunn.
I respect the name. Ooh, Party Crash should have started off getting the first hit. Now, this is loser's match. This is the loser side, so loser is going home very salty. Down again. Just playing this full screen game, trying to make something happening. That was a whiff punish.
Yeah, that jump back one is just going to be absolutely disgusting for Kanye to try to get it on.
Just going into the mix. Back 3-1, stagger into the grab. Very nice by Sir Tommy Gunn. Wow. Kobu's alive?
May not be dead after all.
Are we staring at a zombie character right now? What is this? Still going in, trying to get something going. Wow.
Oh, look at the hitbox on that.
And you know what? Answering with an EX armor move of his own.
It's very similar to Sector's Flames. It's a whole lot bigger.
Yeah, really. It kind of has like a hitbox all around him. It's an anti-air behind, in front, on the side, whatever you need.
Although, interesting enough, did you know that if you clip Sector's right above his head, sometimes it'll hit twice?
I thought you were quicker than that.
Really?
And it does amazing damage.
I have not seen that. That yes. sounds totally intended. Here we go.
Absolutely.
Wow, the mobility between these guys. Now, Newbie did come back with the second round, which is good. But Sir Tommy Gunn is now in this pressure. Swag? Oh, just drops the combo, but doesn't punish the instant jump punch. Wow,
And Kobu is owning the air right now.
What is this character? She was supposed to be dead.
There we go. Chip out.
What is happening? What year are we in right now?
You're supposed to be dead.
You're supposed to be dead. Five. Take it off 1-0 over Newbie.
And that's when Jack kind of feels himself and he goes, hey, am I not?
And here we go. The good trade in his favor. Oh, blocks it. Very nice 4-1-2 punish.
Sir Tommy Gunn in the air has had great reads on countering everything Takeda has to offer in the air. It seems like Kanya's has a little more priority.
And you know what? And he's still going for pretty much max damage. And he's spacing out the Lasher's normals really well with the Party Crashers. I haven't seen Kobu Tanya played like this before. I'll try to do it with the EX Taunt, but that's going to work in his favor, but it takes the round. Listen.
This is an unviable character we're watching.
Yeah, what happened to this character being dead and buried 6 feet underground? Dragon, where is Dragon right now?
Find him.
He needs to apologize. Now, granted, Newbie has not had the chance to really blow up the gaps that Tanya now has. For those that don't know, wow. For those that don't know.
He's playing Tanya completely different.
He really is because he knows that there's a gap in between any of these strings into Rekka's. There's a gap in everything.
And he's just all over the map.
That's it. Tommy Gunn is just...
And you see that whiff dive kick, party crasher. I love it. I love seeing this.
He's playing so calculated and crazy. It's working out for him. Newbie was one of the dark horses to really go far in this tournament, and he's on the brink of elimination right now.
And he made it over at West before he didn't.
Newbie on the verge of being 3-0'd by Sir Tommy Gunn with Zombie Tanya. Party Crasher is not, it doesn't even trade. Party Crasher takes the hit with the priority. Very nice. Doesn't go for the two optimal stuff, but 32% is no joke. Wow, no punish on the instant air dive kick. That was a beautiful read. Beautiful jump back by Newbie. Going in, finally getting some damage in there. Goes right through the gap now. Wait a minute. All it takes is one hit, and there you go, the vertical hitbox. Newbie staying alive.
That looked like it hit her in front, shot her behind, and just, that looked unpleasant to get hit by.
Oh, that would have been a beautiful hit confirm. There you go, that does connect, and here into the mix.
That jump back one.
Tommy Gunn's getting a little bit too impatient right now. He just wants to go in and just doing all these mixes.
And the adjustment by Newbie, noticing that Tommy Gunn's kind of been party crashing a lot, jumping forward, jumping backward, and just letting jump back with one and just dealing with all of it.
Now, this is where you want to be. Newbie has a bar meter both through that gap if he knows that it's there. Oh, for the instant air dive kick. Tommy Gunn's not out of this just yet. And there you go. The back 2-1 catches Tanya in the air. Newbie finally putting himself on the scoreboard 2-1.
There was just a hair bit more patience where you saw him there, see her advance forward in the air, mm-hmm. and just off the anti-air, and early in the round, just to get able to jump back one, whereas Tanya tried to advance to a party crasher. Even on the way down, the party crasher got smacked by the one, and even if she was grounded, got a full combo just like that.
See, and this is perfect adjustment by Newbie. In the beginning, he was playing a little bit too antsy, and now he's taking a step back and letting Tommy Gunn hang himself. But Tommy Gunn is actually playing very well from the full screen range. It's when he feels like coming in that's when he started making mistakes.
That had an awkward hitbox on it. I thought she was airborne.
See, that jump back one is just so good. Tommy Gunn slowly spiraling down here as Newbie is just seems to be making all the right reason. Now into the hard knockdown in the kunai to take the extra chip. Now Tommy Gunn was on the verge of eliminating him 3-0 with quick matches. Newbie is showing a ridiculous amount of adaptation.
And now looks to run away with this.
He's content with maintaining the speed.
This is that first to three that we're seeing where you got
exactly.
Great adjustment.
Exactly.
Now it's on Tommy Gunn to adjust to how Newbie has adjusted to him.
He's just taking his time here. The instant party crashes are still working in his favor.
Shades of the Great Lobo.
Shades of the Great. Gordon, not a hard knockdown. That trade is in his favor entirely. Gets him off the meter at least. But one more hit is gonna do it. Puts him in the mix.
Look at the range on these normals.
And now Newbie running it all the way back after being almost on the verge of elimination here in the loser's bracket.
To run it back 3-0 is going to give him so much confidence going into his next match in losers.
Now, Tommy Gunn thought about going to character select screen. He decided not to, opted to go right back into it with Kobu Tanya, needing to make the change.
And right away saw the adjustment from Newbie pay off already. That instant jump back one.
Oh, too much hit advantage. Wasn't expecting it to go that well for him. No punish there, point blank. Oh, was expecting the wake up, but didn't block low. Newbie just keeping him out. Oh, Newbie tried to let it happen, but the EX arc, I don't even know what to call that, to be honest. But the unrelenting pressure, the mixture between patience and pressure with Newbie is playing out so well.
Yep, and you see Tommy Gunn frustrated whenever he tries to get in. He sees something whiff, he just keeps trying to go for it again. Which is, it's a little stubborn on his behalf, but you know, it worked the first two rounds. And here we go, you see him make a little bit of adjustments. Being even more aggressive.
And he's playing this so he's playing Kobu so aggressively, but in a way that, you know what, maybe it just took Newbie some time to get used to. Tried to bait out some armor there. Very
that
nice
was,
punish.
That was amazing.
There you go, Tommy Gunn in a good position to take this next round.
Ducked, he ducked under the Tafa toss coming back the other side. That was sexy.
This is going to do a lot of damage. Tommy Gunn has no meter. This is a very bad position. Tommy Gunn on the verge of elimination. Newbie with one more correct read. And he's going to meter burn it. This is going to do it. Newbie taking Tommy Gunn for a swim.
Reverse 3-0.
Unbelievable.
Sending Tommy Gunn home.
And absolutely expressionless from Newbie.
From both of them, really.
Now, Tommy Gunn smiled. He's, you know what? He just got outplayed. He knew it. He had a great show in Kobutanya.
This is where Tommy Gunn can stand up, go back into the crowd, get on his phone, hop on Twitter, and say Kobu is bad.
And people will agree.
And people will agree.
People will agree.
What's nice about last year that the other two variations don't have, as you saw at the end there, is that that whip is completely 100% hit confirmable. Mm-hmm. Once it starts, you can meter burn it at any moment. And that's something that's really nice to have as a Takeda player, is that something that on block, I'm not too sure what it is on block, but to have that full combo on hit is really nice.
It is. It is really nice. And the mixture of the aggressive play style that he had was awesome. But, guys, make sure go check out gamechat.com/WBX. Any chat, any gamer, anywhere. They support everything going from Xbox, PlayStation, Steam, and even your standard Android games. You got to be able to chat with people from all over the place, add contacts. So go check it out. Definitely going to be something in the future for the FGC and video games in general.
Yeah, very, very easy to just keep in contact with all your buddies, your teams, your sponsors, whatever you got going on. You can have your local scene separate from your sponsor team.
Exactly.
Separate from different game, your MKX buddies, your Street Fighter buddies.
Think of it more as a gaming social media.
Exactly.
I think that's a really good way to put that. Also, if you're a gamer like myself, I don't just revolve around the fighting games. I play Steam games as well. Also, make sure with the King of Fighters 14 coming out, the Hori pad is now in stock, available at Amazon.com for both the PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 3 systems. In case you like to play with any of the throwback systems, remember, King of Fighters is, I believe, a PlayStation exclusive. If I'm not mistaken, I could be wrong on that.
I'm not 100% on that. I know that 13 was not.
Yeah, 13 was not, but it might be PlayStation exclusive. But either way, Hori, as you guys know, anyone in the gaming community knows that Hori puts out the absolute top quality products. So make sure you guys go check them out.
And King of Fighters is one of the longest lasting and most active fighting games ever. They're in their 14th.
And they're hype. They're so hype to watch, man.
It really is. The 13, after 13 games, they put out what could have been their best game yet.
I think so, too.
Both gameplay-wise and artistically, it was such a throwback. It was one of the best things ever. And with 14 here, everyone's already loving it. They've gotten to more of the 3D model, which I'm sure they're going to work on more in the future.
Right.
But, man, KOF's one of the coolest franchises ever in fighting
games. The first thing that caught my eye was the visual representation. That stuff is – they put so much work into that. Yes. And it looks completely different than King of Fighters, the last installment of King of Fighters.
Yeah,
it's like a completely different-looking game.
And the backgrounds are gorgeous. The animations on the moves are gorgeous. Mm-hmm. The flames, beautiful. I love the game so far.
Yeah, I'm actually really excited to get my hands on it. I didn't really get a chance to play the other ones. But I've always, like KI, I've never played it that much, but I love watching it. But now I just get a confirmation in the chat from someone. I forgot the name. I was right. It is a PlayStation exclusive this time around.
Which, wow. I mean,
for now, not to say that it won't be something later on, you know.
For fighting games, you know, PlayStation's really the move, guys.
Yeah, but while we're getting ready to set up between Conflict and Cloud, I believe.
With the Mecha Blue Phantasma Charizard.
I still don't think that's so. Dude, when I hear Charizard, it doesn't look anything like that, man.
That is Charizard's evolved form, all right? That's what Charizard becomes when Charizard can't do the
job. I'm actually looking at the chat right now. Yeah, Mega Charizard X. I'm going to go ahead and have to hold that. I did not know. So it's going to be Conflict 90's Sorcerer Quan up against Bone Shaper.
And this looks like match. We're right into this.
Yeah, this is definitely a match going right into Conflict. Not going to go with Predator this time around, at least up first.
And Cloud opting not to go with Imposter, which is a pretty good match against all quads across the board. He's stealing trance.
Oh, gets pushed out of the portal. Wow, and back dashes to whiff punish with a back to trance.
In between what could have gone horribly wrong.
Oh, it doesn't get the armor in time. He's going to move away from that portal. That's what Cloud wants.
that's kind of the wild cowboy where he just holds his ground forward.
And he does. And now you look at Conflict, who's going for actually the max damage. Oh, drops a neutral dump punch, but picks it. Wow.
Oh, no.
What is happening? Takes the hit of armor, goes for the grab. Very smart. Conflict taking the first round.
That's where Imposter may have paid off, is where Imposter could get that shoulder off and get the double hit during that missed throw and break that armor and push him out.
Mm-hmm. You know what? And that shows good in-depth knowledge of your own character. To be able to know what your limitations are. Oh, didn't get the hit confirm off of the down three. That would have been so hype.
Down three, stand four, trance.
And this, decided to keep him standing. Right into that portal, he knew that the 50-50 was safe. Very smart by Conflict. And that was a punish.
Yes, that was incredible.
Conflict, a much different player than what we've seen him before. Trying to get Cloud off of his meter. And just look at the meter drain.
He's draining it right now.
Now, he still has the bar to continue this combo, but Conflict is still in a good position here. Will he smell out the overhead? There he does.
It's a lot better than Shinnok having the second bar and building the third.
Yeah, really.
He put himself in a great position there.
Take a sip of my water real quick. I'm dying. I've been doing this for like 5 hours so far.
You're only four in.
Only four in. And I actually get to, I think I play up next. Oh my God, it's already 4 o'clock.
You are in.
Woo. I'm in six. So five and six are the blocks next. So I get to finally get my chance to play. I'm excited. But here we go. Mystic Ermac. I am seeing that. This nothing makes me happier, man. But that is a punish, sir. And Conflict. Playing against me will know this matchup, but it's a matter of Conflict or if Cloud can manage to make the difference.
And Cloud plays every fighting game that there is. The game I've seen him excel at most is actually Killer Instinct, but he loves some NRS games.
Who?
Cloud. He's been playing NRS games the whole time I've known him, but
I remember.
He is a great KI player.
I did hear about that, and I actually am really excited to watch him play some KI later, but right now. He's having a lot of trouble. Oh, and the grab immune normal. Building some meter. The new tech. I love it. Oh, just getting clipped with it.
I'm not too sure what Conflict's trying there.
He's going for minimal damage combos, but at this point, the way he's opening up Conflict.
Oh, there we go.
And there you go. The 1-1 into the standing four. Very nice hit confirm by Cloud, taking round number
Hashtag
one.
Hashtag buff Skydrop.
Oh, almost had a beautiful hit confirmed. Wow, that was a beautiful read.
And Conflict giving up a lot of damage there, dropping that. Look, you could have got a second stand for the trance there.
Ah, and there it is. Cloud had the right read. He did have the right read to make sure to bait that the portal, but unfortunately, the teleport was just a little bit too slow.
And Conflict's showing great matchup knowledge, as you see. His training partner over here, Big D.
Yeah, now, he has played with me a ton of times before, just getting him off that meter. There you go, just trying to keep himself in there. Wow, doesn't take the next hit. That was very interesting. Oh, doesn't go for the hit. Goes for back three lift, putting his life on the line. I have to respect
it. Yeah, that was great. Well, 1-1 using the plus frames to stagger into a 50-50. That is MKX at his finest.
There you go, baits it out.
And that was minus.
Oh, no. Ooh. He didn't know that the jump punch was going to connect. Conflict going right back into it. Mr. Gromax seemed to work it out a little bit for RM Cloud. Now just trying to make something happen here. Conflict putting RM Cloud all the way towards the corner. Taking the hit, getting rid of the bar. Very smart by Conflict.
And this is going to be close to getting another portal. Nope. Barely. Oh, he does get another portal.
Wow, and you know what? And he's getting RM Cloud off the meter. This is exactly what he wants anyway. It's a win-win. Wow. And he wants to keep Cloud in that corner, never getting out. Conflict almost sitting on a bar, but Cloud with a bar ready.
And this is actually really bad for for Cloud now. What's that portal's up and you're in the corner?
It is 1-1, actually.
I respectfully went for there, which was empty jump low, which you rarely see in NRS games, but you see in Street Fighter KOF all the time.
Oh, he gets clipped by it, but doesn't let go, and he just keeps getting clipped by these normals. All right, so Conflict getting pushed full screen. Cloud trying to build some meter and throw Conflict's timing off. 4-4-3.
Wow, look at how active that is.
The active frames on it, very hard to get out. Very nice blocks. Ah, there you go. This is going to do some good damage. Now, they both don't have bar.
A knockdown. Is he going to get a portal anyway? He sure does. That's something that we visually see happen, and we immediately do that run up fast.
My heart just stopped for a second. That's why. And there you go. EX Rune taking the chip out. Conflict taking it up 2-1.
I saw Cloud do something early in that round that I thought was pretty smart, but Conflict didn't take the bait, which is that he did that 1-1. And instead of going for a 50-50, he jumped over looking for Conflict to throw something back at him.
Exactly. And that was very smart for him. What'd you say? No, I'm not. I'm so happy to see this. Mystic is losing, man. He's hard to play. Sup? Get away from my commentary booth, boy. Oh, goes for it. Lays it all out on the line.
All of the commitment.
I respect it. Sometimes you just have to do it. You go with your gut feeling. If it doesn't work, take the damage. Oh, my Lord. The X-ray.
Can we see Conflict space real quick?
And just trying to get something going here. Back 1-2-4. Make something happen. And he's getting hit with these jump-ins. He's trying to be able to go for some sort of anti-air, and it just doesn't seem to be working.
Even Cloud there not believing in that jump into work and having to go for a reset that could have cost him. That throw could have cost him.
Very nice air-to-air and the conversion to be able to hopefully get into the rune here for Conflict. Just staying in that portal, running out of the portal. Backdashing right back in, very smart. Very nice blocks.
You need a full combo punish that strike. That's something that Quan cannot get away with murder on. That was the finish.
Trying to make something happen. Oh, clipping the backdash there. Very good spot for Conflict.
Gets the corner. Gets a portal. Cloud went for his only thing that could have possibly broken that armor at that distance.
Right.
Hard read that should pay off.
Taking the hit of armor. Will we see a teleport? And the standing three anti-air.
What is a stand three?
I've never seen that as an anti-air before.
That was...
Just out of range for that punish. Trying to go for a down three room, but Arm Cloud is on the pokes right now. He's really paying attention.
Catches
going
the back
for the edge push.
And Conflict now woke up three times with backdash and got caught twice for it. Well, if he'd have staggered just the one, just to stay in one, we'd be looking at something really
different. Doesn't connect with it. Now, I like how Cloud is playing more patiently when that portal is out. Down one lift on hit. This man is a god. Why doesn't that work for me, man?
And you see that no commitment there after he was hung. To just hit him with the one hit and let him fall. Very smart by Cloud there.
Now Cloud is bringing this back 2-2 right now. I'm actually really surprised.
Are we going to see the Apex Predator?
We might. Predator. Now, here's the thing. Sorcerer Quan does very well, especially against Mystic. He's playing a few things wrong. Conflict just has to tighten up on a few different edges. Now, I'm unclear as to whether he would want to stick with Sorcerer Quan or if he wanted to be able to take the teleports, try to bait them out with HQT Predator.
Yeah, because Ermac's a whole lot slower than what we saw earlier with Sector, where that laser might not go punished by the time you react to it.
Exactly. It's very hard to punish those lasers unless it's a hard read ahead of time. Conflict's taking some time to think about it. Will he stick with Sorcerer? He's going to stick with Sorcerer. I agree with this decision. I really do. There's really only a few things he needs to change. He's getting opened up a lot by these different jump ins that I haven't really seen, you know, usually wouldn't work on the standard player, you know. So he's trying to anti-air, but it's getting stuffed. So I have to wait and see if he can make the changes. But Arm Cloud is sitting in a good position right now.
Yeah, and in Conflict, as we saw, just in casuals, when he got frustrated, I expect to see him try to read a couple of those with NJP more, but that's just something I'm going to speculate.
Right. Now, Conflict is another one that plays... Oh, doesn't get the conversion down three.
Oh, ooh, right there.
The five-frame neutral jump punch. Making Arm Cloud break. Get him off that meter. Goes for a grab punish. Very nice. Arm Cloud just really wants to make something happen, but he has that bar, willing to spend it.
You see a little more patience out of Cloud too, which is even nice. Oh my, look at the speed that's increased on the meters.
Oh, and this is going to watch it. Look at all the bar that took from that trance. Yeah, unbelievable.
And he isn't done yet. Oh, okay, that might need to kill.
And there you go. That was perfect for Conflict. He got Arm Cloud off of his meter, put him in the corner.
Now, the optimal thing there would have been to do was to end with a rune to take a little bit more meter. But
right.
I'm not going to be picky about it right now.
And there you go. Conflict sitting in that portal, getting the armor, going for max damage. Into another portal. Cloud is in trouble.
This is the grinder.
Still has one bar meter, hopefully making something work. Now Cloud can make this happen right now. And this is how he does it. Get the momentum started.
Keep it nice and simple. Chasing the back dash.
Back three EX push. Arm Cloud is not out of this yet. Oh, no.
If you would have committed there.
That's it. This is going to the last round, last match.
And that was a huge comeback by Cloud. He had...
Like I said, Mystic has one of the best comeback factors in the game. Able to slow down that push, slow down the momentum from any stage in the match.
Just one thing I see Cloud needs to work on is definitely his anti-airs. You're seeing so many staggers from Cloud, and there's just a simple jump over that he's just getting away with.
Now he's just... sit there in that portal, going with the EX push. Oh, didn't
ooh,
see.
No punish there.
See, Conflict's trying to down one after that, and he's getting hit with the crossover every single time. Arm Cloud slowly starting to come back here. Goes for the EX sky drop, pulling out every last trick in the book to make something work. Now he did get him off the meter. He's pushed out of the portal.
Oh, full punch. Oh, no.
Get him off the meter. Coming down to the last hit. And he goes for it. No. He drops it. He's not out of it just yet. What is going to happen? I don't know what's happening right now.
Oh,
he
got
killed with the random stress.
And if you do, huge drops by both players at the end of that match cost both players the win. And Conflict doing his second gives Cloud the win over Conflict 90.
I don't believe it.
Both players had the winning combo in front of their face, and both couldn't deliver.
I can't believe what I just saw. What just happened? I can't.
Back to back chokes.
I can't do this, dude. This game is giving me a heart attack, man. I'm sweating. Just like take it over my face, man. That's my expression right there. That is my expression. What is this? Unbelievable.
Oh my gosh. Out of nowhere, we get one of the craziest sets that we've seen this entire day.
And you got a feel for him, man. That could have went either way.
Mm. I've never seen that before in my entire semi-professional Mortal Kombat career. Two combos sitting right in front of you.
Dropping both of them together.
And one does stand one, and the other does back three. And that was it.
Oh.
Wow.
Now he's going to advance on. That was, I don't even, I don't think that was loser's finals of the pool. But that's a heartbreaker.
Whew.
That
yeah,
hurts.
That may have been earlier.
I'm like, I'm still getting over that right now. I need a second. I'm like sweating for them.
You see everyone around, I'm looking around at everyone's expressions, and they're all like, what?
We have people from other games coming over like, what the hell is going on over here? Because everyone was jumping all over the place. It was hype for the weirdest reason ever. That's the thing.
Yeah, that's what it was. And when the stand one happened and the nothing, I heard so many people go, what?
Oh, it's so bad.
Ooh.
Give me one sec.
That's going to be a hard one to get over for conflict, that's for sure.
Hey, Big D. You want to come in?
Takeda.
He's still in. Yep.
Hey. Loser's finals, right?
All right. Because I have to go get ready to warm up for my pool. Whew. All right, so we're moving on from that.
And we're going to... This gentleman ran into me earlier, and I have no idea who he plays. I don't think about him.
One-arm sword is a mystic. He's a very big fan, and he's a very decent mystic Urmag player.
Sounds good.
All right, so I'm really excited to see him play newbie. We've seen him on stream a few times here today, obviously rocking Lasher Takeda.
And we get more Mystic Urmag for your pleasure.
Yeah, this is great. I could watch this all day long as it's clean. I need to see clean gameplay. But now the winner of this will go on to Losers Finals to fight KP to see who makes Losers Top 16.
I would love to see some good old clean photo play, but... Oh, wow!
That was very good. Buffering that, waiting for it. And here we go. The full screen game, you'll be seeing a lot of this set. Wow.
What?
Was that? Well, I'm going to pretend that was a raid. That was godlike. Was godlike.
Let's say that one of them swordsmen is a god. Right out of the gate.
He is a god. He's one of my disciples. I respect this man.
He took your knowledge and turned it into something even
look
better.
Look at this. I am loving what I'm seeing right now. Patience, hovering, canceling, trying to make him do something.
Any attempt that newbie's made to get in has just been thwarted. Hey, but here we go. Newbie gets something going.
Up gets clipped by the... by the low scoop there.
And doesn't quite have a push. No anti-air from newbie.
Oh, no. He drops it, and he had to spend the bar. Now, he did get the round. Could have saved that bar, but it's going to work out in his favor as he secures the round, putting himself in the lead. Just getting that vertical hitbox in there, trying to make something happen. Newbie wants to make sure he stays in for as long as possible. One-arm swordman finally gets the bar. Will he use it? No, he doesn't.
And newbie doing the hard thing, which is jumping yourself into the corner.
And he's just trying to get, he's trying to mix right now. This is exactly what he wanted. And even if he gets pushed full screen, it works in his favor. And very nice block, fishing for that forward four to hit.
But one of swordsman now has two bars to play with. He's full screen, so you got two pushes. And just like in the first round, look for him to kind of anti-air newbie's attempts in. Oh, just get mixed up mid-screen.
And this damage, very respectable. 36% from Lasher.
One bar hit confirmable, 36%.
You can't count that out. That is very good. And especially when you're mixing that damage and trying to get Swordsman off of this meter as much as possible. Just playing this full screen game. Now, one-armed Swordsman wants to build as much meter as possible. Newbie.
That traded!
Oh, gets clipped by the low. 25% sitting on his last hand.
And a trade.
I love it. Unfortunately for one-armed swordsman, newbie has that trade in his favor. Didn't have enough health to convert off of that.
That was two trades that back-to-back that I didn't see come. When the slam traded with the front flip.
Yep. Now, swordsman is going back to character select screen. Is he going to opt with Mystic? He will. Maybe just need a second. Maybe change the stage a little bit. Just get something going. Ends up being the same stage anyway.
You know, for a 50-50, that stage sure does come up a lot.
It really does. I don't mind it. The pit, I mean, come on, man. How far back are we taking the pit?
I mean, come on. Double dive kick. Double dive kick. Do you know how broken that is?
It's great.
People at home don't know how broken it is, I assume. That's broken.
I mean, you know, it's you know, fair and balanced as we're going on. Oh, armor trading with armor. Newbie taking the better of the trade.
When I see armor go into armor and beat armor, I get happy inside.
It's a great feeling, especially when it's in my favor.
Absolutely.
I love it. Now, newbie going in with the 4-1-2 staggers, mixing up, going for the grab, making sure Swordsman respects every last mix-up. Missing these hit confirms, though, and jumping in the corner.
Oh, big drop.
That is a huge execution error, and 9 times out of 10, that is death. And just mixing them. And there you go. Newbie sitting much more comfortably.
The solid Swordsman we saw in the first round has just not shown up since.
Yeah, you know what? And it took Newbie a little bit to adjust to one-on Swordsman's play. But now even having him managing his meter, making sure Swordsman's using that EX push. He could use it all he wants, but his back is in that corner. And gets clipped by the overhead. Very lucky break for Swordsman.
That's one of those risks you see pay off. And if it hadn't, it's the worst decision you've ever seen.
A nice down one there. Couldn't convert, though. Oh, that is full combo punish, and that might actually do it. Wow, the damage. Newbie going up 2-0.
And what we thought was going to be a different story after that first round has completely turned around.
Yeah, this is looking very grim for one-armed swordsman.
Newbie shredding off 4 rounds.
Now, is he going to stay? Oh, please make my day. Do it!
Punk.
Please, let me see! He's thinking about it. Now, Mystic hasn't been playing too well for him after the first game. He's going to stick with it. I respect the decision. Mystic, newbie, obviously started figuring out how Mystic works for him.
This is Spectral, man.
I am in love.
It.
I'm in love right now. The fact that I get to watch this.
This is Hawk Girl Senior.
Hawk Girl Senior. See, you can't use Injustice Hawk, man. I don't know what that is.
All she did was fly up in the corner and do stuff.
Now you see, that is still punishable, and he doesn't have safe armor in this variation. Now what he doesn't know is that Ermac is one of the only characters in the game that can punish that low scoop with back 1-2 it reaches. But unfortunately, he doesn't know it just yet. Trying to mix him, going in with the cancels. Let's see it.
All right. I fully expected a full run up there and like back 2, levitate canceler.
He needs to be able to do something right now. He's sitting in the corner, has the meter. Goes for that 16%. Trying to throw him off here. Very nice. Does 22%.
That does 22%.
Oh, if he kept going with the combo, is it going to work? And he armors right through it. Newbie staying composed. Oh, that would have been godlike. Swordsman trying to make something happen here with Spectral. Trying to make something happen. Nothing seems to be working. He's getting opened up. Very nice EX Superman.
One of the best reversal specials that there is.
Easily. Yeah. Easily one of the best. 9 frames, 16%, hard knockdown, corpse hop, everything you could possibly ask for, except it is not safe.
Doesn't grant him a combo, but like I said, your ability to punish certain things in situations where most characters can't.
Exactly.
It's a great option to have.
There you go. Full screen. Trying to get something in there, and this might do it. And newbie advances on in the losers finals,
where he will play KP.
I believe now, if I'm not mistaken, Shock. It'll be newbie versus KP now, right? Losers finals.
It'll be KP versus newbie right now. Losers finals. Newbie, I think you're in losers finals now. You're going to be going up against KP. Yeah, once the brackets get, just don't go far. Let me see. Is this for this pool?
Yep.
Newbie. No, they need to go. Yeah, for losers finals, it'll be on stream. And then for that, we'll put
up. You're up.
Yeah. Newbie.
So we will have it.
You know what I just realized? There's two Ryans on the mic.
There's a lot of Ryans here.
There's a lot of Ryans here. It's you, me, Dragon, Silver Eye.
What's a better matchup?
Mystic does well. You just got to be more patient. That's all.
Good stuff.
Yeah, we were up in a hotel room last night, just me, you, and
yeah, Dragon. We had three Ryans
just sitting in a hotel room.
Just playing casuals, just shooting it.
What are the odds?
Honestly, in this kid, there's a lot of Ryans in the NRS community. Shout-outs to Ryan Neal as well, my boy. I miss that man.
My boy, Sorry I'm White Ryan.
Sorry I'm White. His name's Ryan.
Name's Ryan.
Why are there so many? A-OK Ryan.
A-OK Ryan. Is his first name Ryan?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Ryan Mangini.
I feel like that was so butchered. Magnat.
It was.
I just call him A-OK Ryan. I call him Down Player, too, because, you know, he says Goro's the worst character in the game, which is like.
Okay, whoa.
So
whoa,
not
whoa,
true.
Whoa. Maybe.
Yeah. If you're watching Ryan, stop. Stop the propaganda. It's enough.
What Decay is going to do to individuals later is going to disgust you.
I'm actually really excited to see what Decay does.
I have heard horror stories of what Decay does to people with Goro. I haven't seen it yet. I've heard horror stories.
Decay's Goro is like actually legit.
Oh, yeah.
If he took the game very seriously, oh, my God.
If he could attend NRS Pop Bonus Games, he would.
Kosher Ryan in the stream. Ryan confirmed. Best name. You're damn right it is. So here we go. The run back. Will newbie come back?
Isn't Wild Cowboy's name Ryan?
Ryan Cowboy's Ryan as well.
Hey-o.
All the best players are Ryan, man. All right, so now we're opting with a different variation here.
And he is all over Katana Prime.
Oh, very nice that one. He's going to go ahead and chip him out here. Newbie taking the first round pretty convincingly. But KP sitting on a bar and a half a meter. Could easily be able to switch up the sides here and get at 42% at the very least. Oh, goes for the armor. KP not having enough stamina to break, going to take the rest of this combo.
And Newbie's been all over it. Like, almost every decision KP's made, Newbie's had an answer.
That was a very interesting situation how that didn't connect. The KP trying to zone him out here, just going in, but Newbie just placing out those flips very well.
And I expect an immediate switch to back to Assassin.
Yeah, this is exactly. I think he wanted to test the waters. I don't agree with him going with that in the first place.
I completely agree.
Going right back to Assassin. Newbie going up game number one. Now.
Is KP feeling that pressure off that loss?
KP's not really one to play on tilt. All right, so KP going back to Assassin, which is what got him the win against Newbie earlier today. Going in finally with some decent damage here. Woo! 43% is not bad at all.
And for a character that was labeled as having no damage.
That's almost like the pre-patch damage. And beautiful use of the 4-4-3 to switch positions. KP taking the first round, keeping Newbie as close to the corner as possible. And this is the part where he could just come, like, keep his space, zone out, and then bait the flip kick in the air. Very nice use of armor. Wow, the back dash over the back two, very smart.
Great read by Newbie there.
Just trying to get in. Now, I believe that was a read by Newbie with that parry, but didn't believe it. That jump over would have worked, giving KP the edge to be able to make something happen here. Oh, just gets clipped by the neutral jump punch.
Which is a massive neutral jump punch. And Newbie's two in that round alone that he's playing out of his mind.
Newbie is playing extremely well right now. KP is just trying to get these instant air fans, make something happen. Back two. Just clipping him out of the air. Oh, very nice catch. Instant air fan down one into the sharpen. Very nice. Newbie doesn't want anything to do with this corner. KP has an X-ray. Will he use it?
It's coming on the grinder to where
it is.
He might need it.
He might need it, or sooner or later he's going to have to break. Because the newbie actually has a little bit of a life lead.
There we go.
Now, but here's the thing.
It's
this is not going to kill. if newbie touches him, it's death.
And he cannot kill him in one hit if he had armor.
Very nice. That was the most instant air fan I've seen in a while. KP going on the scoreboard, 1-1.
And the crowd getting into it. I heard a few guys in the crowd chanting KP.
The crowd wants. They want. KP obviously is the fan favorite, being the personality that he is. 4-1-1-2 into that sharpen. Goes for a down two, quick 17%.
Look at the range on the jump. That was three-quarter screen.
And he was ready for it. Lazier has great tools to be able to contest this footsie range. Taken.
And Dash looked like a good trade for newbie on the kunai versus a fan.
Wow, just goes for the raw scoop.
Raw
pays off.
Scoop.
KP has to break. Going in with some pressure. KP needs to make something happen, and eventually he was going to get chipped out. Newbie staying as on point, taking round number one.
Let's see if KP can get out of this corner, because immediately he was in a bad position.
Now this is newbie's in the perfect position right now.
Now the first game, you remember all the good reads with the wake up DPs, and we haven't seen any yet.
No, not one. And you could see the difference in play style that both these guys are playing. They're baiting out each other's armors, but the punishes just aren't there, and the drops are all over the place. Goes for the back one, whiff, into the grab. That's like the KP special, man. He does that all the time. Trying to get these instant air fans, getting the jump punches instead. He needs to be careful.
Yeah, that trade looks to be in Takeda's favor when the kunai trades with fan.
Very nice spacing by newbie. Backstepping, getting the whiff punish.
And just, oh, here we go.
There you go, giving him the life lead. He's trying to bait out that armor. The whiff punish goes over. It's just a scramble right now. And there he goes. Wait a minute.
That could be it.
Not like this.
And that's going to do it. 2-1 newbie. What a display.
How did he jump out of that string? He must have known the distance was too far for it to jail. Very smart.
The world may never know.
KP is on his last legs. He wants to make top 16 here in the loser's bracket. But newbie is not ready to be double eliminated by him.
And this is where we said that we thought newbie was going to be a dark horse here.
He's
proving it.
He's proving it right now. He had a little bit of a rocky start, but KP, one of the favorites to go far in this tournament. Very nice blocks. Goes for the grab instead. Keeps it simple. Trying to even out this life lead. Very nice read on the kunai. This is going to do some good damage. Newbie is opting to not break.
Yeah, absolutely. He'll hold on to that meter lead. Unless he opens up right now.
He has to break. Next touch is going to do it. Newbie has the meter. And no! And very nice grab. I couldn't even breathe for a second.
I expected for that to be negative enough unblocked for another armor to come out.
I was waiting for it.
And that's what I was waiting for.
There you go. Very nice parry. KP finally getting into the swing of things.
Taking the momentum and move and using it to his advantage right now. Positioning is perfect. The meter.
Oh, very nice. Back two into the low scoop immediately. Very nice blocks. Oh, still gets hit. 22% for a hit. Here we go. KP getting some damage of his own. Very nice down one in the grab. Newbie, one touch. We'll be able to take the next round.
And he's going to keep this. Oh, no.
Not like this.
Oh, big drop by Newbie.
Oh, no. And he gets clipped. This is really rough. This puts KP in a tough spot. KP is not ready to go out of this pool just yet. Now, both these players have made top 32 just being here, but to advance into the top 16, they have to eliminate each other. Wow, catches him. Gonna be able to get some decent damage here.
A Katana Pro moving forward to do an instant air fan.
Very nice stagger. He's just trying to get something happen. The buff is up, 14% grab. Wow, the read!
The
that was so hype!
And that's gonna do it.
And here we go. It is 2-2. Game five, guys. The winner will advance. The loser's top 16. The loser is going home.
That was a great knockdown.
That was amazing.
That looked like he could have set some stuff up.
He needs to be careful, though. He cannot get ahead of himself. Newbie is as composed as they come. Oh, tries to low scoop. It does not work. Gets clipped.
And he's already had two great reads, now three great reads on Katana Prime starting game five.
And Newbie's just perfectly spacing out those air flips.
Oh, I have expected one there.
KP's trying to make something happen, and Newbie just keeping his distance with the Kunai. Kunai is a really good tool in this matchup. Newbie is on set point to eliminate Katana Prime from the tournament here in Loser's Top 32.
And unlike last time, he's got meter going into to what could be the final round.
Now this is where KP thrives, to slow down this pace.
Oh, three in a row. Can we get four?
Baits it out, has to break.
This is really bad for Katana Prime.
This is looking really rough. KP, going to do it. KP has been eliminated from the tournament.
And Newbie takes it 3-2.
So Newbie is now in Loser's Top 16. KP, unfortunately, eliminated.
And look how just composed he is sitting there.
So KP is definitely, he's not happy.
Yeah.
Walking off a little bit. So it's rough, but it happens.
Yep.
You know, both players played really great, went down to the wire. And Newbie just staying composed, managed to clutch it out, get in a few mixes in there, and that was it.
And some big reads. It was well played.
It was well played by both.
Completely different player than what we saw in Winners. Completely different player.
So now, moment of silence. But you know what? It's not that he didn't play great. You know, it's not that he didn't play great. He played his heart out, just unfortunately, just didn't manage to edge it out. But now we are going to be going ahead to get into brackets 5 and 6, I think.
This is going to finish.
Oh, this is losers finals. Putting a heart next to your name and sign up for an Injustice side tournament, man. All right, so.
Damn right, I'm gonna sign up for Injustice.
I really need to go warm up for my pools.
Is KP not willing to commentate?
I am afraid to ask him.
What is he too afraid?
You ask him.
You want me to ask him? You want me to ask him?
Nah, I got
a Quotal player? I play Blood God, you know.
He just needs a second, that's all. He just needs a second. So we're going to have Cloud going up against someone I do not recognize.
KP. KP. I need you to come on. I got to warm up for my pool.
Guys, I hate to leave you like this. Ryan. But I got to go warm up for my pool and get ready. I play at 5. So, guys, it was a pleasure.
It was.
As always, I'll be seeing you around. And thank you.
And pretty soon we'll have probably KP back here on commentary as I try to write in the names for these guys. I have no idea. Oh, here we go. They're already in there. This is going to be Hazard Blank, which means this means that Hazard Blank may have upset Kevo. No, Kevo made out Winners. What bracket was I looking at? Who? Did he upset somebody? I'm not too sure. Where's that bracket?
Round one. Fight.
Yeah, this is going to be Hazard Blank versus RM Cloud. I think this is Torment. Let me get it together, guys, real quick. And swap and save. And here we go. Hazard Blank, who I'm actually not too familiar with. I have not seen him play before. Using Covert Ops Sonya. And RM Cloud kind of going for the day one stagger there, which is zero on hit. Probably look to throw or maybe go for an overhead. Try to catch Blank off guard is where you're expecting the laser, which is really plus on hit. And oh, I think he saw. He got lucky there. I think he saw that Blank had a breaker and tried to end that combo and go for something unclashable. But was able to clutch it out. Gonna put Blank here, yes. What we like to see from Rushdown characters is when you use hard knockdowns to push forward rather than go for like the immediate Oki, not really respecting the wake up and get that extra push to the corner as you saw him just run into the wake up. And we'll see if Cloud can turn this round around. He has the meter to do it, goes for the not mix up. So some plus frames here in the corner. I guess he's trying to catch him interacting out, and that's going to cost him the round. Ooh, no stamina to do his combo. Oh, what about that breaker? That was so risky. Oh, I'm going to be joined by EVB Dragon, ladies and gentlemen. And Cloud was able to mount a huge comeback there. Sorry, as I get Dragon settled here. Does that microphone fit you?
Yes, it does.
Okay, there we go.
I don't know what's up with this. Okay, there. I think that's better.
You have to adjust it a lot.
All right.
It's all good.
I think it's good. All right.
And we got RM Cloud and Hazard Blank, which we believe is Loser's Finals at this pool. With the biggest Charizard you are ever going to see in your life.
Yes, I saw that. Dude, that's godlike.
He's channeling.
I need one of those.
He's channeling the power.
I need a big alien one.
Oh, and the switch of demolition, which is a good switch no matter who you're.
Yeah.
No matter the matchup, really.
Yeah, this is probably 6-4 demo, to be honest.
You know, that's not very easy. Getting that dive kick through the flares.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. Fortunately for Sonya, she is one of the characters that can get through health sparks sort of easily. Not super easily, yeah. But she can. Zoning by Shinnok, his base control. Here we go.
And you saw Blank go for it again there, but really, but he had the one mid where he could have gone for a trade on the flare.
Ooh, oh. Nice uppercut for an anti-air.
What a down two Shinnok has.
That was great. Ooh, Wrong. Right in the face. I actually like that. No one would expect it. Ooh, drops the combo. Oh, this is where he needs to go in. She has no grenades. Don't let her reload. Okay, or do that.
And this is Cloud, who's coming off of what might be the upset over Conflict in an absolute epic match.
All right, I like this. Don't let it reload, ever.
You gonna throw the baby? Here we go.
Yeah, he's... Oh, okay, he didn't need a... Here we go. Oh, the one mix, reload?
Oh, he could have caught
it. Oh, he still gets it, though.
And Cloud looking very strong in what I think could make top 16.
Yeah, I'm really liking this Shinnok play. He's playing really well.
And what got him here was a switch from Bone Shaper. He switched to Two Big D's Delight, Mr. Gurmek.
Oh, wow. Okay. Ooh, tries the gun. Nice hit confirm. Here we go. Oh, okay. We're going for
and,
ooh.
And swag.
All right, goes for the reload. Oh, drop the combo. That was
good. Cloud, I was about to say, look at the meter that Cloud is sitting on right now.
Yeah, he's sitting on a lot. Ooh, here we go.
And the, the non-mix-up mix-up?
Yeah.
It's pretty easy to fuzzy, but it can't catch
it. It works sometimes. Yeah, here we go. Getting him again. Not ending it in time.
And he opts to go for what was zero instead of the plus frames with the distance.
Yeah, he can opt to do that. Hazard Blank is not showing that he knows what to do about that.
That's the day one Bone Shaper.
Yeah, I really like that Cloud is abusing it because Blank does not know what to do about that at all.
Oh, nice little corner push here from Sonya.
Just goes for reload. Ooh.
Yep. Let's go for reload and Cloud all over him for it.
Oh, wow. Let's go a block.
You couldn't even see it.
Yeah, you couldn't, man. The nade was in the ground.
Reload, and what's Cloud going to do?
He goes for the overhead.
He's going to eat it like a man.
Yeah. All right. She only has one grenade now, so I'd be aware of that and try to make her waste it and then go in. Oh, that was really good. Tried to fuzzy, went for the low.
Shades of Wow, there's nothing happening, and then four.
There it is again, here we go. Okay, now he can just zone.
Yep, and then you just keep tossing those bad boys. Don't let her get it.
Oh, she got it. Oh, I could have done. Oh, okay, I like that. Nice. Oh, it doesn't get the combo.
Big drop. Ooh. I'm not sure if that was a punish. Cloud was just blocking low.
Yeah, I think so too. Wow, that actually hit. Here we go.
And nice jump one, jump back one is no joke.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
That was a good clip.
Nice grab. I like it. Sonya does have two grenades.
Watch out, boy. Watch out for the defensive wake up.
Yep.
He's going to throw the baby.
Oh, it goes through the health bar. Here we go. This is going to be down to the wire. Oh, my God.
Look at the max distance on all of that.
Oh, my God.
That was disgusting.
Total jump-ins here.
Do you see it? Shades of Kotal's jump one. That was cancelable into a full combo. Hey!
In your justice, Dave!
Alright, nice back dash to avoid the mix up. Alright, we got some zoning going on. Ooh, health sparks. Ooh!
Did not pay off that time. He went the same exact max distance jump one.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Blank does not know what to do about it. He's respecting it every single time. So I like Cloud going for that.
Oh, that's just gorgeous spacing by Cloud. Just playing keep away and bullying her without grenades.
Perfect. I like it. Dude, I really respect Cloud for just ending it there because Blank doesn't know what to do. Oh, he jumps in just to get hit by the overhead.
That's the Sonya special. When she sees a empty jump coming.
Exactly. Okay, opts to not spend the meter. Just going to save it for a full screen game.
And I've noticed so many trades on flare and grenade toss that where it's just putting them back in a neutral state. That Cloud's winning.
Yeah, exactly. Now, Shinnok does have the meter advantage here.
He just jumps right out of that grenade. Wow, the balls.
Oh, gets hit. Oh, she has no grenades now. Oh, he gets grabbed, and that's a full reload right there.
I fully expect a yellow scoop coming. Oh, here we go.
This is it right here. What's he going to go for?
And he has the meter.
Oh, that time. Ooh. Okay.
He would have built a bar if he'd just done a 4-4. And just get the basic.
Yep. Definitely.
So that was a one-timer. Not keeping a basic didn't pay off.
Oh, my God. That's that. Oh, wow. Just goes for raw 50-50. Doesn't even try to convert.
And ran a little extra for that push.
He did. I like it. Full combo. And the full reload. Oh my God. That was a fully delayed dive kick right there. You waited until the last second.
And it looks like Cloud was sitting on a flare, just kind of waiting, but didn't pull the trigger.
Yep, didn't. All right, is Cloud going to change characters? I think Cloud was actually playing Shinnok really well.
Yeah, I wouldn't change, but you know, the man's made it this far, making his own decisions.
Yeah, definitely. I think he got a little bit too impatient.
Here
sometime.
We go.
He jumped in, or he ran in, or he did something where he could have just stayed back in zone.
Yeah.
So we'll see if he can kind of make some adjustments. And we'll see what he can do here.
Yeah, and testament to Cloud, where he thought about the switch that saved him earlier
in
the tournament.
He did.
But thought it through his head.
He thought
said,
about it.
You know
it.
What? I'm going to stick to it. I played well enough.
There we go.
A couple better decisions.
Yep.
Oh, for sure. And I know what he was going for there. That back two in the flare, which is a true block string, but a lot of people like to press the button.
Okay, all right. I was wondering what that was. Ooh, put him in. Oh, okay. Ooh, that is punishable. No punish, though. No punish on both both moves there. Cloud looking really in control here. Just needs to stay patient. There you go.
And here we go.
Cloud on match point here.
Blank has so much meter to mount a comeback, but if he makes the comeback, it doesn't have to be either going to the third round. That's where everything gets dicey. And he's already off of two bars.
Yep, only has one bar now.
That's always something you should be thinking about mid-match is not only this round, but the next round.
Yeah, definitely.
And preparing ahead.
Oh, yes, for sure. Ooh, goes for the scoop. Here we go. Going at nice. I like it. Both sitting on no bars of meter here.
Oh, didn't commit.
Nice. I like the delay.
If Blank had committed, it'd be a whole different story right now. But Flare won. I mean, God, one Flare away from taking this. Oh, and the double backdash.
Oh, my God. Goes through health bar.
His converse is... percentage on that is staggering.
Yeah, one thing you have to be aware of in this matchup. Ooh,
and he's got the blocks. He
won. Oh my god. Oh my god.
He
hits him with a raw shoulder charge.
What is going on here? As Cloud takes
raw shoulder charge.
Wow.
He got impatient, but it worked out in his favor, so I respect it.
That was great. What was it looked like his walk forward throw worked. It looked like it worked, and I was about to freak out. I was about to scream like a girl.
Yeah.
But then the nade popped, and he still had the balls to just do it.
Oh, my God. And now that I think about it, actually, he was at a life percentage that I feel like anything that Sonya would have done would have killed him.
Yeah.
And
take the risk.
Yeah, and got the round. So why not just try to do that if – he does his meter correctly, then you Shinnok builds a little bit of bar.
Exactly. At worst, you get meter.
Yeah, and if you mess up your meter, then Shinnok hits you and he wins, like, which
exactly
happened there.
That's something that not a lot of people take into account, is that what in that situation, in your mind, don't – if you block, you give your opponent meter going in the next round. Whereas if you get hit, you
exactly,
get meter.
Exactly, yeah.
And if you get your wake up, you get even more meter.
Yep,
for
definitely.
For the special move and getting hit.
Yeah, that – honestly, like, that's one thing that I do a lot. A lot of games, I'll honestly, I won't give up the second round, but if I take a big, like, 40% chunk and they're at 100%, honestly, I'll try to gain as much bar as
exactly
I can. And you'll see me a lot of times with 3 bar and they'll be at, like, 0.
Yep.
I want to use all my resources the last round and just put everything there.
If I'm up a round.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Up a round, yeah.
If I'm up a round and he just half-lifed me, I'm building bar.
Oh, yeah, definitely. 100%.
And I'm trying everything I can to make him come off whatever he has.
Yes, exactly. That's what you do.
And this is Losers Finals. This is to make top 16.
This
we've got
Buffalo?
We've got the Buffalo.
The Buffalo. The Tom Brady's child here. No, not really.
But we've seen him using not only Sub-Zero, but Sector doing well.
Oh, he's been using Sector, really.
He used Sector against... Conflict's HQT Predator.
Oh, wow.
Knowing that he would make the switch.
Yeah.
And man, oh man, did it pay off. He was reading every projectile with teleport. It was disgusting.
Yeah. Wow, that's awesome. Okay, so here we go into it. Buffalo gets the first hit.
It was the biggest mind game I've ever seen, where Conflict, he knew Conflict might not have favored the Quan Sub-Zero matchup and would pick HQT, and had counterpicked his HQT counterpick before the game even started.
Yeah, that's really good.
It was great.
Wow, neutral jump punch hitting there.
If he would have converted that, that would have been sick.
Make some break, I like that. Goes through the delay, Buffalo not falling for it. Let's get hit. Ooh, nice clone. Here we go. Gonna take him all the way to the corner. For the clone. When is Scoop going to come?
All of the respect from Cloud here.
Yeah, a lot of respect.
And that is round one.
Nice. And he ends it with Slytherin. Just built that little bit of meter to end the round. I like it.
All the little... little things that Buffalo was doing earlier with Sub-Zero to build bar have been really sexy. It, instead of clone cancel, he's been using ice bomb, all kinds of things. It's been really it's really fun to watch.
Awesome. Here we go. This is going to be a full combo into hard knock down into clone. Okay, that was interesting.
I guess he tried to get him pressing a button there after.
Possibly,
and
yeah.
And even the armor, and that would have broken armor.
Yeah, definitely.
So very smart control by Buffalo.
Yes, he is very dominating, showing that he knows his matchups in and out. Oh, I think he tried for a clone there.
Yep.
Buffalo in control. He just has to play patient. When you have this much of a life lead, just play patient. Like, stay happy. Yeah, like that. That was good. I really like Buffalo's play right now. He's playing super smart and solid.
Yes, and he barely lost. I think it was 3-1 to Kevo. In Winners Finals.
Kevo's a great player.
He actually took Kevo off of Molina with Sub-Zero.
Really?
And then Kevo used Buzzsaw.
Wow. That's awesome.
Which is definitely something I saw coming as a Virginian because we saw Kevo beat Brady with Buzzsaw at top of the food chain before.
Yeah. Goes for the armor. Here we go.
And gets max damage here. Back two off the ice bomb. I can't even do that. I'm not that good.
Now, if I were Cloud there, I would not have spent that bar. Don't spend it. Oh, he spent it.
Yep.
In my opinion, I wouldn't have spent it because most likely you're not going to win this. I watch him win this.
No, right. He's winning this.
Oh! Oh, goes for the slide. Okay.
He danced as much as he could.
He
could not avoid the killing blow. But built the bar back in the process.
Yeah, he actually did. Wow. The ice ball actually hits him for the double hit. Oh, misses the combo.
Big drop. But you saw Claude delay his wake up, so he didn't really get anything off that whiff.
Yeah, definitely not. Oh, that clone is so close to him. There's the grab, and that should be it if he doesn't drop the combo. Yep. There it is.
And round two. Goes to Buffalo. Buffalo one round to make it top 16 at Summer Jam X.
Playing so clean right now. I love it. Now, will Cloud switch to the A2 alien match? Okay, no.
will he throw acid?
Yes. Now, how old is Buffalo? He looks quite young.
You know, I'm going to ask him the moment I'm off his commentary.
Curious.
Because when the moment I saw him, I want to blow him up. I was like, did you even watch Ninja Turtles as a kid? Do you even know?
All right, plus on that clone throw. Oh, whiffs back two, no punish though. Okay, he's in the corner now. Misses neutral jump punch. Oh, this is a full combo here. Into clone,
Everyone's saying he's 13.
13?
13 years young.
Wow.
And doing grand, he's,
this?
How is he the grandmaster at 13?
Dude. Now this could be.
We call that a protege.
Yes, this could be.
Oh no, he's gonna combo.
Wow, very nice. Sonic Fox started competing when he was 13 too, didn't he?
And it's another animal.
Yeah.
No.
Sonic
Buffalo is coming.
If he's this good now, he's gonna be such a phenomenal player later on in his life.
Exactly. When you're this good this early, it only goes up.
Unless
Injustice 2 comes out, and then you hate the game mechanics.
Tries a raw trance there. It seems like Cloud is not sure how to deal with Sub-Zero. Ooh, tries the EX Ice Ball there. When that aura is up, he has a hit of armor, so it's going to be hard for Sub-Zero to do something. Okay, now his chance. Ooh. Okay, armor.
You see the swag little meter build.
I love that. I didn't know you could see that. That's awesome. All right.
Swag meter build by Buffalo here.
All right. Cloud could come back from this. Set up. Okay. Here we go. Now he might. I would run up and uppercut him. That would kill. Let's see if he does it. I'm not.
I think.
If he's a savage, he might. Oh, that almost hit.
If he didn't have the awareness to do that. Skull, he was landing on that.
Yeah.
Without armor.
Yeah. Slides in, tries to get a little bit closer to the corner. Clone cancel.
He might have got a back one too off of that.
Yeah, I think so. Oh, wow. Just pokes right through that. Okay. Here we go. Drops a combo. Nice neutral jump punch, though. So,
and I'll tell you what, you are not beating that in the air.
No, definitely not. The Lerma. All right. Has the rune set up. Ooh, got the armor. Ooh, I like it. Pushes him out of... Oh, no, he jumps back into the armor, though.
And here we go. Stand for Trance. And we're going to get a corner push, and he may get... Yep, he's going to get one more...
Oh, no. That was huge. That was absolutely huge. This could be it for Cloud. That...
Not having the portal and having your opponent cornered, that is not... Oh, but he missed
the ball. No punish. Oh, nice delay, and he hits him. This should be game.
That was such a late conversion, too. It looked like he didn't have that ready.
Don't pull the conflict. Okay.
And Cloud.
Okay.
Too soon.
Yes.
Rest in peace.
Wow. Okay.
But Cloud, big turnaround. Yeah. Buffalo was running away. Oh, my gosh. Was that even the little Peter Bell?
I love that. That's awesome. Okay. Just the little things. I like it. I like it.
Look at the conversion off the air-to-air with back two. I've never seen that before. Oh, big drop,
though. Drop the combo, yeah. When you drop a combo with sub, it hurts a lot more than other characters because he doesn't get his hard knockdown into clone.
His set play, as it were.
Yeah.
Great by Cloud there.
Very nice. Now he won't be able... Oh no,
that's... Okay. Came off the bar. I don't know about that. And then wrist it all.
Yep. I feel like he sort of had to go for a wrist there, so I respect it. Yeah. All right, here we go. Buffalo on match point here, game point. Oh, raw trance in his face. Oh, my God. He's probably going to get armor here soon. Yep, there it is. Oh, wow. I've never seen that string just like when close up to each other. It's crazy.
You know,
wow.
I've seen a few quantities just because it's actually it's neutral on block.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. All right, this is going.
Oh, the teabag.
Was that a teabag?
He teabagged at the end of a game somewhere in Winners.
Buffalo is a little nasty 13-year-old. He's got some stuff.
Savages in these streets, man.
Oh, okay. I like it. Backdash into the aura.
Cloud looks so comfortable with spacing between him and his opponent.
Yes. He's spacing him very well. Has a lot of control over the neutral here. Oh, gets hit by the two. Oh, this is bad. He's in the... Oh, no! He didn't do the neutral jump punch!
And that's going to do it. And he does the teabag.
Oh, my
God. And Buffalo takes it. 3-1. The little 13-year-old Savage has advanced.
Very
top
nice.
Top 16.
By Buffalo.
Here at Summer Jam X.
That's awesome.
Powered by Twitch.
13, top 16. I wonder who he has to play for top 8.
That was loser's top seed, so he has to go through two.
Oh, two, that's right. Yeah, I forgot about that. Okay.
And, all right, so going over the pools now, we've got Destroyer in Winners, RM Forever Elite in Winners.
Okay, Forever Elite in Winners. Wow.
Forever Elite Upset Illusions, 3-2.
I heard that. That's
3-2.
Dude.
It is on YouTube right now. I already put it there. I recorded it and already put it there. It was an amazing match.
Is that it for game four?
That is it. Then we have Kevo.